Hello. Don't know if anyone's here yet, but I'm just making a coffee. Hope you're all well. Oh. I've updated the chat rules. I actually put some effort in. Who'd have thunk it? Although I don't think anyone's going to fall foul of them, to be honest. We all have a similar vibe. Right, oh, let's make all the drinks. Do 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 do. Now it's been ages, so my levels might be all over the place, so please do shout if this shit. Because like a true professional, I didn't test anything. Almost there. I haven't even opened up Visual Studio. Oh, anyway, whatever. One problem at a time. And then hopefully, I don't know if Dream is on later, but hopefully we can go and all say hello to him a bit later on, where he'll be using some of the TwitchPlays. I imagine if he's doing Faz, he will be anyway. He's, as far as I know, he's the only one using it at the moment. Right, aircon, I think you're going to be required today. Yeah, you'll have to let me know if that's coming through on the microphone. Oh, I didn't even turn the kettle on, you fucking idiot. Well, we're not dual streaming. I thought about it. But I am going to record it to put on YouTube. I am pretty convinced. In fact, I'll tell you what, we'll have a look at the TFS in a minute. Because, oh, which mug do I want? Oh, I've got so much choice. I'm gonna have my VK mug. Toki and his sword. See it in a minute. See it in a minute. Oh, I've got Haribo as well. Oh, hello. I've just brushed my teeth though, so we're not having Haribo this early. That's. I could be tempted though. I'll wait for the toothpaste taste to die down, and then yeah, maybe we'll have some Haribo. I do have vodka as well, but it's definitely too fucking early for that. Sworn twice now. I'm not supposed to be swearing, am I? Come on, kettle. We're nearly there. You can do it. I couldn't imagine waiting in North America on 110 volts for the kettle. Holy crap, that must take forever. I'm impatient about that taking probably what 1 minute 20 that's just taken. It will take, and that's 3.2 kilowatts. So it'd be half that in America. Far too impatient. I suppose they like their machines more over in America, don't they? And to be fair, they're quite popular here too, like your little Nespresso and you just put the shit in and press a button and then come back later and it's done. So I suppose it's just a different thingamabobber, isn't it? Right, what's the betting? Twitch didn't send any notifications out. Imagine. Right, OBS, why are you capturing the wrong screen for a start? Let's fix that. Primary monitor. Yes, thank you, please. So then OBS can go over there. Awesome. I should open mob view, I guess. until one of my 5 bazillion mods arrives. And, oh, I need to start my closed captions as well. Not closed captions. Oh, there we go. I did actually do it. Fair play, fair play. All right. So does that actually work? Let's see if this is... Is it working? Oh, it does. Oh, it works. It works. It works. Fantastic. Okay, cool. I think we're winning. Are we winning? I think we're winning. If I click the button... Wait, where's my webcam? Hello! Where's my webcam, though, on my actual... Oh, because that's not the right scene. I know how this works. Okay, cool. Right, super. Probably should have checked that I didn't have anything compromising on my desktop. No, I don't think I do. So, let's do VS Code. Bosh. And this just pulled up work, so let's not do that. So let's do WSL. And let's do CD into code. What do I call it? TwitchPlays. And then code. Local workspace. Here we are. Right, I should turn the volume of this music down a bit, shouldn't I? Or is it too... Is it too loud? I don't know. Let's be super professional and just unmute my stream for a moment. I am quiet though, aren't I? Why am I so quiet? Not sure. Hey, Cass! How's it going, sir? How is it going? Let's open Discord. How you doing? How was your holiday? I assume you're back home now, are you? I completely zoned out from everything the last 2 weeks because work has just been stupid. Right, so now I can do Discord. I can't spell, that's a good start. Discord presence, reconnect. There you go. So now it says in Discord what I'm doing. Oh, it was saying that anyway because I'm streaming and it's done the thing with the thing. Oh, okay, never mind. Oh, yeah, because it's in streamer mode. Okay, whatever. Already back at work. Ah, oh, damn, dude. I've actually just booked some holiday. I'm not going anywhere, but I've booked end of this month, Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday off, so I get a nice long weekend and 2 short weeks. Top tip. I fucking love doing that. And then similar only at the end of August as well, except one of those days is a bank holiday, so it's free. Right, so actually what I want to do, let me just open this again. Can I open this again? Let me just get set up and then I'll change the scene over. Because, you know, I need one more screen. Ugh. I refuse. I refuse to do it. Right, okay, cool. And then let's just start a new file here because I am coming prepared today. I actually have some reference notes and things. New plays. In fact, no, let's put it actually in the stop pie. There we go. And then, okay, think I'm ready to click the button. I've already clicked the button. Never mind. I'm an idiot. When did I click that? Well, whatever. You have a day off for your birthday on the 26th of this month. It's the day before I go off. Of July. I'm going to put that in my calendar. As I do birthday. As I do, I mean, that should have an apostrophe. Click. CC. Ah, very good, very good. Right, what I should do is uncomment these to make it bigger. That's what she said. And save. Hey, look at that. Now we can see what we're doing. Is that big enough? I probably don't think it is, actually. Font size, let's make that like 15. Still not overly happy. 16, I don't know. Ugh, that's going to be horrible on my end. Right, okay. Toothpastey blackcurrant. Delicious, my favorite. So, GPT. It's all the rage, right? I'm clipping. Why is my microphone quiet and I'm clipping? Ah, what is this? You crazy microphone. But can I do something in SteelSeries to like make that not do? Mic test. Ha 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 ha. No. Is the short answer to that? Well, never mind. I thought that counts. Let me know if the audio is like really, really shit. That software, SteelSeries. So it's the manufacturer of my headphones, my new mouse, shiny new mouse. First time I've not had a death adder in like 10 years, and keyboard. And it all comes into here. So yeah, there you go. You can see the sort of see the things. And I can change all like the colors of the keyboard and you know all that usual sort of bullshittery. Stop swearing. Usual thing for the mouse or your binds and whatnot. And then on the headset, you can change like all your equalizers, and it does a virtual audio device thing. It's really good actually. So the microphone comes in. And then it puts out a virtual audio device microphone. So it's after it's gone through all of its noise cancellation software routines and stuff, because they're all in the software. I don't know if there's actually anything in the hardware, but you also have these three different audio devices here for output into the earballs. So game is what I currently have the music playing on, but when I'm in a Zoom call or a Discord call or something like that, that outputs to chat. All comes through the same ears, but if you see that you've got this mixer at the bottom, I can change the wheel on here to adjust the balance between one or the other. So if I've got music on and someone starts talking to me in the Zoom call, I can just go that way, and now I can't hear the music. I presume that doesn't change it on your end. No, you can still hear it. I can't hear the music at all now, but I would be able to hear the Zoom call fully. And then if I want to mute them, I can just do that. And then in the middle is just max of both. And then this media thing is a new thing they've added, but it doesn't really work. It sort of just overrides both of these, but you can have a different equalizer and volume and stuff. I did try it, but. Good idea, like it, it's got legs, but not yet. The only problem is Windows is a butt face for it, or a lot of apps are a butt face for it, because like I'm playing this in Groove Music for some unbeknown reason to me. But you can't, because this is a native Windows app, you can't choose what device it outputs to. You can only do it down here and sure, you can go in and do the fine tuning, and there is a way. There's some disgusting menu somewhere that you can do it, but it's just such a faff. It's like, oh, can't be bothered. Whereas, like in Discord, you can just say, output to this device, please. Thank you. Done. It's just that easy. But anyway, run over. Right then. Shall we do some ChatGPT? Right, it's not ChatGPT, it's GPT-3. I can maximize that, can't I? So down here in the corner, I have this thing called Copilot. In fact, I can just show you the... it's a Microsoft thing, GitHub Copilot. Here. And it uses the GPT-3 engine. It's been trained on GitHub, effectively, and presumably a load of other stuff. It's usual scumbag Stack Overflow, I would imagine. I don't actually know. And it basically, it's a code suggestion thing, right? So it's glorified predictive text and autocomplete and all that sort of stuff. So I have been using this for, you get a 1 month free trial, right? And I highly recommend doing that trial. If you're a student and you've got GitHub student account thing, GitHub for Education or whatever it's called, you get it free. So if you're part of a campus program, I think you get it free as well. Otherwise, it's like a tenner a month. So I'm trialing this on behalf of the company. That I decided that I was doing it on behalf of the company, I might add, to see whether or not it's worth, you know, getting the other guys to have a play with it and seeing if work will pay for it. So the end of my 4 weeks is next week, I think. It's Tuesday, yeah. And it's a no-brainer. Hey, Red. Good to see you too, my friend. Oop, burp at completely inappropriate time. Sorry. Hope you're well, dude. Really good to see you. Yeah, it's a no-brainer, and hopefully you'll see why, right? And forgive the clickbait Twitch notification of, is it putting me out of a job? That's obviously everyone saying that. Hopefully I'll be able to prove that no, that is absolutely not the case. So let's put my shebang in there for no particularly good reason. Right, so what are we going to do? I'm basically doing a show-off of this stuff, and let's see how useful it is, how good it can be, what its downfalls are, and just get a little bit nerdy on it, right? So why don't we do that? So we know what TwitchPlays is, right? We know loosely how it works. It's got three different parts to it. Are you working? Oh, cool. Egyptian Phasmo. You're going to have to explain, what is this Egyptian Phasmo you talk of? Is this has someone just gone Phasmophobia and Pharaoh and just gone, have at it, boys? Because that sounds right up my alley. Yeah, well, hopefully I don't send you to sea with a load of code in, mate, while you're working. Oh, forewarned, yes, of course. That's had a big update recently, hasn't it? So I've heard. Or sort of recent enough. So, right, let's put some words on screen, right? So if anyone joins, they don't go, this guy hasn't got a clue what fuck he's on about. So anything in grey here that's to the right of my cursor is like you would in normal autocomplete or predictive text. This is what GPT is suggesting. So what it does is it can look at what I've currently got in my workspace. It sends that up to the GPT engine in the cloud, GPT-3. It's not ChatGPT, it's a different model, but anyway, I think that's just becoming the terminology, I suppose, isn't it? And then it sends back down the recommendation, right? And I can just hit tab and it types it for me. Now, in this case, I don't actually need that. Well, I will need that library later. But anyway, so Scatterbrain, TwitchPlays, three parts, right? There's the chat, connect to Twitch chat part of it that's sucking in all the chat messages and making them available to me in the code, what people have typed. Then there's the parser, which is then going through those messages and looking to see if any of them match with things from our configuration file and trying to find some sort of action and do that matching and say, so they didn't just type a smiley face, they actually typed a TwitchPlays command, I need to do something with this. And then the third part is the actual execution of an action, which is your keyboard or your mouse inputs and scheduling those to happen in time and so on and so forth. Hey, Mew Mew! Pickle? It's pickle green! There you go, yeah, it is a pickle green. Oh, but you can have pickle purple. I've made some sauerkraut, but with red lettuce. Red lettuce, red cabbage. So, yeah, it's just not coming up on the camera, is it? Never mind. I thought I'd give it a go, because I make kimchi, and kimchi's delicious. But I've never made sauerkraut, so, really. So, what we're going to look at is the actions part of it. Because before... Right, this was the key map thing, right? This disgusting complexity of Doom, where there's a command and it's like got keys, it's got some function, it's got buttons and durations and, right, all this, and then, yeah, number of repeats and there's dictionaries. It is so overly complex, right, and all these different methods. And it's just getting, it's too unwieldy, right? Developing on that is just, you have to sit and look at it for an hour before you can press the keyboard just to get everything in your head of what the fuck's going on, right? It's just not intuitive. But it's first iteration, so you know, I'm not bashing myself. So, how are we going to do this? Well, with the aid of GPT, because it's made some really good suggestions when I was dicking about with this the other day on my laptop. On my new green sofa, ha! Yeah. Oh, hi, Mew Mew. I wonder if that's something I can assist my end. What am I outputting as? Is the stream good for everyone else? Because I got a new router 2 days ago, so hopefully it is better. I could actually play Valorant without it buffering yesterday, which was quite nice. 600k a sec. Don't particularly think that needs lowering, does it? I don't know. Any of the professional guys know? Good for you guys. Okay. Mew Mew, get better internet. Sorry, dude. I'm winding you up. Green sofa stream when? It's a chaise lounge. I can't show you what it looks like, actually. We're not going to write a single bit of code today, are we? You just know that's what's going to happen. So this is the one I've got. And it's, it's no longer on offer. Get wrecked. I got it when it was on offer. It's a bit darker green than that, and my walls are like a poppy red colour. But yeah, I just... That is lovely to lie on, actually. It's really nice. It's quite firm as well, which I like. Yeah, I know. It's a big improvement to my old sofa, which was the only sofa I've ever bought, and it was from a charity shop, and it was very old and torn and ragged. Do I even have a picture? I thought I did take a picture. So that's what it looks like. The camera's like colours aren't doing it very good there. It looks grey and dull. It doesn't look like that at all. I thought I did have a picture. Well, that's sort of one of them in bits. You see how disgusting that is, right? But all the cushions were torn and all the white fluff was, you know, hanging out of it and all that sort of stuff. So, yeah, it was a bit shit. I don't think you can pick the resolution for non-affiliates, because they don't put any processing power into my stream to downscale it. Am I doing 60 FPS? I don't really need to do 60, do I? Um, I can't change it without stopping the thing there, can I? Yeah. Okay, I'll note that for next time. I'll review whether that bitrate can come down. I'm not sure. It's a long time since I looked at the numbers. I just copied it from some recommended thing. Right, okay, let's put some words on screen. So, we're going to look at the actions, right? So that abomination we just looked at, let's make that better. And we're going to start off by making a protocol. In other language, this would be an abstract base class. And it's basically just a... so you can see it making suggestions here. None of those are what I want. But to be fair, it's not got much to go off at the moment. So we'll let it off. Let's see if I can actually type. That'd be good. And then from... No, not from. Let's just import data classes. Okay. So we're going to make a protocol. And we'll make data classes. See, there you go. It's just straight away. I just need to press tab rather than typing all of that. So it's... Oh, it's going to cheat now because it knows I've done this before. Oh, that's a little annoying. So it does already have a bit of knowledge of the stuff I was messing about with. Oh, that is a bit annoying, actually. But to be fair, it's just recommended the wrong thing there, so I'm just going to type what I want. So I want an action, and I want this to be a protocol or an abstract base class. And interestingly, what it's done there, and I just press tab without even thinking, is it's overriding the dunder call method. So if I was to then make an object of this, so let's just say x is an action. Oops. Right, to make an instance of this class, I could then call the class as if it was a function, which is a bit weird. So then I could actually skip that step altogether by doing that, which is just a horrible notation and I don't like it. And I prefer not to override dunder methods where possible. So actually, I don't want to do that. In C++, that would be operator overloading of the bracket operator. So what I want to do is create a run function. Okay, it's going to take itself in, and dot 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 means it doesn't have an implementation because this is an abstraction. So we're going to say now that anything we create that is an action must conform to this template, as it were. And it's very, very simple. All it means is anything that is defined as an action must have a method called run that takes no parameters and doesn't return anything. It's meta, basically. Now what I can do is put some not in there though. Excuse me while I figure out how the hell you program. I can do that, an action. Okay, that's not actually what I want. So I want this to be a protocol for actions that can be a run. There we go, something like that. And then this is run the action. Okay, so we're just defining, you know, that this is what everything should look like. Now that is different, but does it run? Run, rabbit, run, rabbit, run, run, run. So this is different to what we did here, where we defined a command and then just made lots of different instances of that command. So we would spawn in, you know, x equals command, here's a bunch of arguments, and then x is spin. Okay, and then we could define another one, which is y equals command, here's a bunch of arguments, and that is teabag. Right, rename y to teabag. So we're doing it in a different way. We're doing it more in a I don't know really what the paradigm would be called. So, I mean, the other way is object oriented. I suppose it's not really though, is it? I don't know. Whatever. Whatever. I don't care. But now we can start building on this, right? So everything's going to be a data class. Just because they use fewer lines of code. They have issues, performance issues, but they're not going to be the bottleneck, so the performance issue is going to be irrelevant for this application. So what we want is an action... So we've defined this protocol. So everything conforms to this. Now what do we want to do with it? So let's say we want to repeat an action. Can you see all this grey text here? This is ChatGPT, not GPT-3, GitHub Copilot, suggesting what I should type here. So I could just press tab now and it's written this entire class for me. I've not had to think or write any of it, right? It's quite interesting. But as we get into it, we'll see the nuance on this. So we might want to repeat an action, right? So for example, teabag is repeatedly pressing C a few times, right? Simple as that. So let's call it an action repeat. Okay. Now, interestingly, this is trying to do it by inheritance. So GPT now is saying, or is suggesting, that we want to inherit this protocol, which is not how protocols work at all. So an inheritance is bad practice in Python anyway, for the most part. So actually, this is wrong. So is it going to replace me? No. Is the TLDR? No, it can't. But it does replace a lot of tedious boilerplate punching the keyboard, writing trivial stuff. So I can just look at something and go, yep, that's right, and do the more novel stuff, because GPT is not novel. It can't be. It's not intelligent, despite it being called AI, which is hilarious. It can only predict based on what it's seen before. Loosely, there's a bit more to it than that. But... wow, Nightbot, chill the fuck out. So action repeat. So this is going to repeat an action. It's going to take an action. So this is composition rather than inheritance. So it's going to have one of these in it. And the number of times to do the repeat. And then the run method, because it's got to have a run method if we want it to conform to this protocol, is going to do for x in range this, and we've just put dunder because we don't actually need the variable, run the action. So if times is 5, it's going to run the action once, twice, thrice, 4 times, 5 times, and then exit, and then we're done. So GPT has written this for me now, so I can just hit tab. I don't need to type any of that. Predictive text gone mad, right? There we are. Now it's suggesting that I'm going to probably do another one. Okay. Action sequence is actually what I want next. So it just fucking knows, right? Now, annoyingly, as I said before, I have been playing about with this, so it does, I presume, have knowledge of what I was playing about with the other day. So you'll have to take it on good faith that it was doing exactly this when I was writing it for the first time the other day. And it's just insane. And I've been using it for 4 weeks at work, and it's pretty impressive. Doing much more complicated stuff than this. That is fairly predictable, actually. But we can do some cool stuff. We'll get onto the cool stuff in a bit. So run actions in a sequence. So this is going to take, right, a list of actions, and they could all be different. So we don't actually have one in TwitchPlays at the moment because we don't have the ability to do this. But you could have different commands like forward crouch, left crouch, left crouch. Or the, what's the one, the time tell workout, you know, forwards, back, left, right, 360, that thing, right? They're all different actions. And what this will do, and I can just hit tab on this because I can see this is correct. We're going to give it a list of these actions, go forwards, go back, go left, go right, blah, blah, blah. And then just say, run it. And it'll loop through all of these actions in turn, one by one, and run them, one after the other. Simple as that, right? This is, at the moment, we're just defining what the things are. Or you know, how things work, should I say. It's called a framework. Ah, okay, so now it's trying to say, oh, well, maybe now you want a press release key action. Not yet, we're still in framework. So we might want to be able to repeat this sequence. So we might have a sequence that is, trying to think of a good example now in Phas. I don't think of one, to be honest. But as a hypothetical, you might want. Oh, okay. Yeah, here's an idea. You might want to crouch, then pause for a bit. And then crouch, and then pause for a bit, and then crouch, and then pause for a bit, rather than just go like that. And pausing is an action. So therefore, those two things are mutually exclusive. They're different. So pressing C, i.e. crouch, is one action. So we would have a two-action list. But rather than just doing, just listing that multiple times, say, crouch, pause, crouch, pause. I mean, just say crouch, pause, and then do that five times. A little bit easier, right? So let's do that. So we want an action sequence repeat, and it's just based on action SE. It's saying we want an action sequence, which is correct, which has this list within it. And then a number of times. And that's fairly trivial. It's very similar to the action repeat. It's just this time we're looping over a list. But we've already covered the looping over a list here. So we don't need to re-implement that. We can use what we've already got. So we just you know, repeat that. Now, we mentioned about wait or a pause. Let's do that. Action sequence repeat forever. So it's now making suggestions. I've not done this because I can't see a use case for it, where you would ever want that to be done forever. Although I'm curious what it's going to do. Is it going to do as a while true? Yes, a while true. So there's just not a use case for that. You would never want to do that in Phas. But we do want a wait, right? This is just a pause. Just do nothing for a moment. So wait for a duration. The duration is a float. And then the run method is just time.sleep for that amount of time. Excellent. And then I need to import time at the top, don't I? And have I got my sorter on here? Yes, I have. And my formatter. Yeah, fantastic. Okay. So actually, wait is our first real usable thing that we can do. Hey, Maud! Long time no see. How are you? Hope you are well. Hope it's not too hot. The sun's out here. It's been quite rainy recently, which has been nice. Now, on the back of this wait, right? This is for a hard-coded amount of time, whatever we specify, right? What if we want to wait a random amount of time? And this is one of the things that I was playing about with the other day, is injecting some randomness into Twitch plays. And I think this is just going to be like the icing on the cake. I think this is going to work so well. Because, like, for example, Dreamer, who uses Twitch plays on pretty much every stream, he plays Phasmo, is getting very, or is very good, should I say, at dealing with the trolling. Now, remember, for the spin, we put the spin is a random angle that you go back to, so you can't guarantee that at the end of the animation you can be facing the same way you came, or, you know, the opposite direction or something. And that's added a lot of spice, but we can do more. with this random stuff. So let's do a weights random. Weights random. Here we go. And GPT immediately suggests wait for a random duration. We want a minimum and a maximum. We want to run this because it's a an action, so it knows that it must have this method here. Note it's putting type hints, all the comments in and stuff like that, which is really, really good. So we're going to time.sleep for a random uniform distribution between minimum and maximum. That's perfect. This is exactly the code I wanted it to write. We need to import random. Import random, and it knows that's what I want to do as well. So what's cool about the about it putting these strings in is when I then hover over this, it gives me that information, which is really, really nice. So obviously here I can see the implementation, but if I was in another file and I wanted to do x is weight random, it's even suggesting between 100 milliseconds and half a second there, look. And then I just wanted to run that immediately. I can hover over this run and it tells me run the action, right? And that's just this text here. Which actually isn't very intelligent here because it's just copy and paste that down. So let's go and tweak some of these. Yeah, I haven't been here in ages. I haven't streamed in ages. I've not streamed in months and months. So don't worry about that. Yeeting my smudge on the ground while the ghost approaching me. Yeah, I survived. Get in. What is that? Kekwa Disco. Oh, I love it. Some of your action in the chat room. How? Oh, yes. Yes, I remember. Yes, I do remember this. Holy shit, hacks. That's all I'm saying. Dirty hacks. No, that was very... Yeah, just how. Oh, God, I do remember that. Have you still got that clip? Streaming less and being online less. I completely agree. I've noticed it in a lot of the bigger streamers. A sense of desperation. A couple have said to me money is not as good. Struggling. I've had people reaching out asking for me to mod. Because, you know, the mods have got life. Yeah. I feel for a lot of people who have taken up Twitch as a career because it's not on the side of the smaller partners and almost partners and affiliates. It's very much not sustainable, I don't think. So have the clip. Feel free to post it, mate, if you've got it handy, but no pressure if you're busy. Right, I just want to quickly add some of these type-ins because I'll forget, sorry, these comments. Repeat and... Actually, no. To be fair... No, I think it's fine. Oh, in my test code, I didn't even... No, I did add it for some of them. That's a bit inconsistent. Oh well, whatever. Okay, so we've done weight random, right? So what other things can we do here? We're sort of falling down the path now of writing what we think we would need, which is typically bad practice. You should really only write things when you need them. This leads to a lot of code bloat, but I... No, I'm going to need all of these because of the test code I did the other day. So this is not necessarily best practice if this was first off. So just bear that in mind if anyone's watching for on the YouTubes later for programming tips and so on. And actually, yeah, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll do one more and then we'll start actually running the code and then we'll develop it in a more sensible way. I think that's probably better for those guys who want a bit of education on the YubTubs. Oh, cool. Let's watch it.
The fuck you are, you're not. I don't know what the fuck you are, you're not a yokai. No! No, 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 no!
Ain't no way. I cannot believe. Yeet. So that was a Twitch Plays yeet for anyone watching. It didn't intentionally yeet a non-lit sponge stick right when he was about to. That is amazing. I've got to save that clip actually. Choose another folder. Clips. That's gone into it. Right, here we go. Am I going to do anything controversial here? Probably not. Clips. I only have a few clips here. And you're on the list now. Well, no, it's been... I've got some really good ones in here. They're old school. These are all Among Us. And Susan Williams. That's fucking gold. Anyway. I digress. How many more of these have I actually got to do? Quite a few. So I'll tell you what we'll do is I'm just going to put a divider in here. And let's actually do some... Oh no, I've only got two more to do on my list. Until it's the weekend, brain is very much given up. Right, next one on my list. Action sequence repeats with wait. Perfectly named. Action sequence from list. Okay, so that's a factory. Oh, because I've done death. Haha. Action sequence. Sequence wait, so that would be a sequence of waits, which seems pointless. Just wait longer rather than wait a short amount of time multiple times. So that sort of doesn't make sense. So ChatGPT, you're on notice. Sequence repeat. It's thinking about it. With weights, there we go, it has actually got it. So we're going to take an action sequence, we're going to repeat it a number of times with pauses or waits between each repeat. So you can probably see where this is going, right? Actually, oh, that's done it differently to what I did before. I quite like that way of doing it. So before I had wait as a float, so just a number, and then this was time.sleep, the wait time, right, which is a bit dumb because, sorry, self.wait, because we have a definition for what a wait is, and it could be a random. But actually, I like this way, so let's go off piste a little bit. Yeah. I'm super glad you liked it, mate, because, yeah, after the thing that happened, and I was a bit scared that all this effort had gone to waste, and it... And, you know, things happen, but seeing people having fun with something I've written... Bear in mind, all the other code I do is, like, to make a company money, which, you know, isn't fun, so to speak. But yeah, and seeing friends benefit from this is just, makes me happy. So we're going to take in an action sequence, we're going to do it a number of times. Wait, does that make sense? No, because what we should do is take in an action action. No, because we're going to make an action sequence repeat, aren't we? So, yes, this does make sense. Do we want an action with weight? Have we done that? I suppose it doesn't really. Why would you want to do something and then wait and then exit without doing something again afterwards? That sort of makes no sense. Okay, fine. I've talked myself out of that. But we might want to do a sequence and then a pause and then do the sequence again and have that as a loop. So, for example, you might want to do flashlight on, crouch as the sequence, and then we might want to repeat that five times with a pause of half a second in between. So crouch, flashlight, pause, crouch, flashlight, pause, crouch, flashlight, so like a combination of disco and teabag. This is going to be really, really easy. You'll see in a minute how easy this is going to be to make just chaos. So we're going to take in an action sequence, so flashlight, crouch. We're going to repeat it a number of times, and we're going to have some weight in here. And I am tempted to default this to a random. Or we could say a weight random. So this can either be a hard-coded wait of half a second, for example, or it could be a random between some min and max. Now that'll mean it'll be the same random time between each repeat rather than a random time between each repeat. Does that make sense? So if the random came out and said it's going to be 0.3 seconds, it'd be 0.3 between each repeat rather than 0.3 at the first one, and then it calculates it again. Maybe it's 0.8 for the next gap, and then, I think that's better. Because you could just get, like, it turn out if it's a really slow repeat. Imagine teabag being over, like, a minute. And it's like every 10 seconds it just crouches you. And you're just like, doink. Like, you might not even know it's happening. You might just think that someone's typing crouch in chat. But actually, it's this sequence playing. Oh, that could be quite good fun. Okay, I like this. I like that. Oh, and we've missed one out here, actually. We might want to do an action repeat with wait. So rather than a sequence, crouch and flashlight, we might just want to do crouch, wait, crouch, wait, crouch, wait. So a single action rather than a sequence, yeah. Which is what teabag is at the moment. So class action repeat with wait. Okay. And it's worked out this time because I did. It could be a random wait. It's learned from that. When I say it, I mean GPT. Or it's taken that into account, really. It's not learned. But anyway. And then we're going to do the action. This code looks correct to me. Repeat an action with a wait between each repeat. See, even like in human readable words is very good at explaining what his thought process is. Oh, I don't like saying that. Yeah, okay. I particularly like anthropomorphizing it. Giving it human qualities, I guess. Okay, right, cool. Let's just do a quick format of this. So we've got our framework here. Right, so this is probably most of what we're going to need in terms of like structure. So let's actually start making things that do stuff. So let's just put a divider in here, something like that. So let's make it the same width as that. There we go. Ah, that's interesting. So that's what you quite often put at the top of a file. So our most trivial basic action that we can do is pressing a key. Yeah? So let's do that. So it's a data class, and it's going to be press key. Press it. So here we go. GPT says, yeah, press a key. We're going to take a key, which is a string. You know, just be like the letter A. So it's a single character string because there is no single character type in Python. Not natively, at least. And the action for now is we're just going to print to the screen. But in here, we will just swap that out for the library call that sends to Windows, press this button, please, that actually presses the button. But just for testing at the moment, we'll just print what it would do to the screen. So obviously, if we press the key, we might want to release a key. Yep, and it's figured that's exactly what we want to do. And we're going to just say release key. Okay, cool. So if I do if name equals main, just our usual stuff here, we can make a sequence now. Oh wow, okay, look at this. It's pretty much just made a load of test code. So what's it saying? Just print hello world. Okay. Fair. Quite like it. So an action, we're going to make a sequence, press key A, wait half a second, release key A, and then we're going to run it. Okay, I quite like that. And then it's going to make that same action again. Seems somewhat superfluous, but actually I do quite like the layout. And then we're going to convert that into a repeat, and we're just going to repeat that three times. I quite like this little test it's done. And then it's going to do same thing again. Oh, that's interesting. It's figured out a way. Because an action sequence is an action, we can create the action sequence repeat class without even needing it. That's quite clever. Okay, so that actually gets rid of some code, doesn't it? So we don't need this class. Because you can make the class. Ah. Interesting. You know what? I'm just gonna stick a breakpoint on here. And let's run it. Let's just see what happens. Can I just F5 on that? Is it going to run the right thing? Yes, it is. Okay, cool. Right, so let's step through this now. So it's going to print hello world. There we go, hello world down here in the terminal, right? We're going to make this action and we're going to run it. So what do we expect to see? Press A, wait 0.5, release A. Okay, pressing A. There was a pause. Maybe I should make these pauses longer. Maybe I should have it print to screen when it's doing that. Actually, let's just do that. Let's just quickly do that. Print, waiting for... There you go. See, it's just made that debug for me straight away. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this out into a variable. Wait time is that, and then it's so this is where GPT is really, really good, right? It just knows that's what I want to do, and it's typed the string out for me. Waiting is an F string, so it can put the actual variable into the string. That's just saved me 5 seconds of typing, 10 seconds of typing maybe. But when you're not explaining this to chat as we go, those times add up very, very rapidly. My productivity has gone through the roof. So let's do an F5 on this. Okay, so let's try that again. Run. Pressing key, waiting for 0.5 seconds, releasing key. Perfect. So now we're going to do that. Same thing again, but we're going to do it three times. Run. One, two, three. There you go. Hope you saw that pop up in chat. I should probably put a divider in here. Print. Let's just do an empty print statement after each run. It should just give us a new line. Just a bit of a nasty way of getting a new line in there. And then that's all we want. So let's run that. So pressing key A, waiting for 0.5, releasing key A. We should probably put a wrapper method in here so we can actually print out nicely what the action's gonna be. That'd be nice. So one, two, three. So it's just repeated that once, twice, and three times. This is all very testable code. I like this a lot. So now we're gonna do this exactly. We're gonna do the same thing, but in a different way. So we make the sequence. This might be a bug. No, it is. It's done exactly the same thing, but with a different class, which makes me think. So, what's the difference between that and that? So, action repeat and action sequence repeat. Action times and then for loop. Oh, they are identical. Interesting. So does that mean these two are identical as well? That takes an action sequence, but they conform to the same thing. An action sequence isn't a protocol. So it makes no sense for it to. Yeah, I can just delete this code. Oh, I love deleting code. Action repeats with weights, which takes an action. Action sequence isn't a thing. So that's the smell. That's the code smell. There is not using the protocol type. Let's just check the rest of these. Takes the protocol type, which is this abstraction here. And these all just take an action. Okay, wicked. Oh, brilliant. And that's removed three test cases because that does the same as that, as does that, I presume. So we're taking in our sequence. I don't know why it didn't just define this at the top. That would have been, but anyway. I suppose this is it's thinking about different tests. Honk! Wait, have I got honk? No, have I not got honk? Oh no, but I do have this. Look at that one. Sniper, hello. Right, I need to go to BTTV because this is unacceptable that I do not have honk. Wait, is it BTTV or is it FFC I'm using? No, it's BTTV. Wait, there's a limit in B. Oh, I can't remember. BTTV. Here we go. Here we go. Ka-ching. How are you guys doing? Happy weekend. Goose Riders is that what it's called? That's even better. Honk. Look at all the choice. I quite like that one. Do we want the same as Mork? That was quite good. That's a proper 3D model there by the looks of it. Oh, I'm sure they won't mind. I like that one better. Add to channel. There you go. Have at it. Yeah, I'm good, thanks. I'm good, thanks for doing a bit of nerding. A bit of nerding out. Hey, Quarian! Good to see you, my dude. Oh, I saw your Discord message the other day. Did I not reply to it? Yeah, I did a little bit of Phasma. I was introducing a brand new player, actually. I'd never played it before. We'd done a couple of games. It's quite good fun. But yes, today we are. So, I can delete all of this code. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. So, we are using what is colloquially called as ChatGPT. It's strictly speaking, it's GPT-3, whereas ChatGPT uses GPT-4 to help programming. And I've been using this for the last 4 weeks at work, trialing it out. And I must say, I have been very, very impressed. My little clickbait go live notification of, is it putting me out of a job? No, absolutely not. Does it make my job much more interesting? Because GPT can all do all the boring boilerplate punching the keyboard stuff, and I can do the novel thinking. Yeah, it's just brilliant for that. Very, very impressed so far. It does write a few bugs. So you do, you do have to vet what it's doing. So here we go. It's done the pressing of a key. It's done that as a repeat. So what's this one? Action repeats with wait. So it's going to do this sequence. Press A, wait half second, then release A. So it's just like walk forwards a tiny bit. Then it's going to wait half a second and then do it again. And then wait half a second, and it's going to do that three times. So actually, this is identical to this one, except with an extra wait at the end. Oh, I messed that up. Control click to copy. It says, yeah. Not something I use often. So it's effectively that these two are now sort of pseudo equivalent, I guess. Okay, so let's see if that's actually what happens. F10. Yeah, okay, I need a better way of printing this out. So it did that, and then it's injected this extra wait. That wasn't there before, because before it was releasing key and then immediately pressing, whereas now it's releasing and it's injected this wait here. Yeah, okay, cool. Totally over your head. Yeah, that's fine. Soon AI will produce Terminators and we'll get our apocalypse. Yeah, I know, right? Have you tried Bard for coding? No, I haven't. Interesting. So what I'm using... what do you do, Sniper, if you don't mind me asking? So I've been using GitHub Copilot. You get a 1 month free trial, basically, and then it's like a tenner a month. Or if you've managed to waggle an education account on GitHub, it's free. But for a tenner a month, so I decided that I was going to trial this for my company, and then feedback at the end of the month to the other guys whether they should try it, because it won't be for everyone. Like, one of the old boys at work, this would drive him absolutely insane. So he's not going to use it. That's fine. But some of the others will be like, this just makes everything a lot easier. And it is, yeah, I'm very impressed. No, Bard, I haven't tried. So Bard, thing is, it's not intelligent. So if they got... I assume they haven't got an integration to VS Code because Google, not Microsoft. Although this is, they're quite open at VS Code, which I like, which is why I think this is such a good bit of software. And Atom before it was very good. No, I haven't tried this one. I just like the integration. I think the integration is what makes this. And there is a Copilot chat as well. Have I even got this installed? Yes, I have. Let's have a look. Which is your more traditional ChatGPT thing, where you can just ask it a question. I don't even know how to do this. How do I do this? I don't know how that works. GitHub, yeah, I'm signed in, doing all the things. So how do you do? Oh, I don't know. But yeah, so the integration is basically it's sending up to the cloud the stuff that's currently in my workspace, and then runs it through the model and then sends straight back down the autocomplete suggestions. It's really good. And you can there's an option in your GitHub as to whether or not the code that it sends up gets stored and then used to retrain the model, or you can disable that. So it's disabled for me because obviously I use this for work and we don't our code is not for public. Yeah, no, not negatively meant at all, Corin. It's fine. IT manager at corporate firm. Nice. So it'd be copy paste. Yeah, gotcha. Yeah, so I mean that it throws an interesting question, right? Is so say Google did create an extension for this, and then some other company, Musk's new thing when he said AI is evil and wrote that open letter and then set up an AI company. Anyway, whatever. There's going to be different options, and it'll be very interesting how you could have them running against each other or something like that. I don't know. This is my Twitch plays, by the way. You guys haven't seen this over in Mork's community. I wonder if do I have a working version of this somewhere? TwitchPlays. No, I don't. Can I make a working version of this? In fact, I can just download a working version of this. And I can show you what it does because it's funny as fuck to put it lightly. Like blowing my trumpet too much. This one is probably okay, so let's download you. Yes, Windows, stop moaning that I refuse to pay Microsoft for a license. Let's just make a new folder. What's one more new folder? So config. But I know my own name, Green Giant. I'll have to change some of my key binds, but that's okay. So now can I run this, or is Windows Defender going to be a bitch? It's going to be a bitch. Connected to Dr. Green Giant. Okay, right. Steam. Haven't used GitHub in years. Oh, don't tell me you're a Bitbucket person. Oh no. My two companies ago used Bitbucket and Atlassian and stuff. I'd already replied to sue me, by the way. That's I appreciate it. I just closed that. Let's fire this up. Yeah, GitHub, I must say, I find it much more user-friendly than Bitbucket. You just don't use that sort of version controller. Yeah, fair. Yeah, I use Git very heavily, and then GitHub is just the sort of thing for it. Right then, okay, let me change a couple of key binds because I haven't. This version of TwitchPlays doesn't work with control being crouch. They still not fixed that bug yet, where it says waiting for input, even though it isn't. Okay, kinetic. I promise I'm not as salty as Hypo. Almost, but not quite. Right, so we should be working. Let's just check. We'll enable that. Right then, so if you type forwards in chat, I'm hands off, right? So go for it. So you've got commands forwards, backwards, left and right. All right then, or not. My code is shit, clearly. Press W and then wait 3 seconds. Oh, it's working. I wasn't tabbed in. Ha! An idiot. Yeah, have at it. Actually, before you do that, let me just do... Have I got a command? Yes, I have. There you are. There's some of the commands, right? Let me go make a coffee and you just go nuts with some of those commands. And it also sort of proves that clearly I'm not pressing the buttons. It's you guys doing it. So the special commands. So there's teabag. Disco won't work in the lobby. Spin. I've forgotten what the other ones are. They only have a 50% chance to work. But there is a bug where the timeout only starts counting if the command works. So if it fails, you can just immediately try again. So you can just spam it until auto mod gets you. But I think I've got that turned off. So yes, let me just make a coffee. Oh, I could have a biscuit brew tea. No, I want a coffee. And I have Haribo as well. Oh, get in my face. So, yeah, this is old version of Twitch Plays. It's hilarious. In fact, shall we do a quick game? Because some of the regulars will be... will know exactly how this can be fun. In fact, I'll show you a Shill Knows clip first. Because it's so broken. So much fun. Oh, yes. Yeah. So it started off as Twitch Plays. So the idea being, you know, if a streamer's making a cup of tea or whatever, and Twitch try and complete a round, that's impossibly hard. You need someone else in there to open doors because it's not, you don't have the fine control for doing doors and things. My sense is really high. So it's turned into Twitch trolls, really. And a very good example of this is in a Shill Knows. He's just sent me this clip, so let me find it here.
I don't know what the fuck you are. You're not a yoke.
And there's the yeet. So in chat, and I think it was me, actually, someone typed throw or yeet or drop also works to yeet his smudge stick as the ghost is coming up the stairs.
I know what the fuck you are, you're not a yoga.
Yeet! And somehow, unbelievably, he managed to pick it up and light the smudge. There's no way. So, anyway, that's the sort of thing you can do. There's also talk is a command, which is hilarious because typically during a hunt, because streamers use push to talk, right? During a hunt, you just sat hiding. So you talk to chat, you know, catch up on messages and so on. Sometimes talk in chat, it press and holds their push to talk button. So they're talking in game and the ghost hears them. So let's just go butt wild on it, shall we? Let's just do a strangle word. And then I'll enable. So, yeah, you've got all the things. Exclamation mark TPC to get the list of commands. Does it work with the word anywhere in the chat string? No, it has to be at the beginning of the string. And I think it's case insensitive. So actually, if I show you the config, so let me zoom in on this. So forward, Presses W for a duration of 3 seconds and has a 5 second cooldown. Left, back, and right. Crouch is on a 1 second cooldown, so that's just absolute chaos. Pick up, grab also does the same thing, so either of these words will press E. Place for F, you don't really use either of those, to be honest. Drop throw yeet is like the best thing ever. That's on a 15 second cooldown. You know what, let's go crazy. Let's just make it 5 seconds. Fuck my life. Switch, change, or swap is cycle through your inventory. Journal, flashlight for your American folks, torch or light is just pressing T. There's your talk. Press and holds for 5 seconds, so 10 seconds. Special commands, teabag, disco cycle, and then there's mouse commands, so look right or turn right moves you roughly 45 degrees to the right, I think, and peak is just half of that, and then there's spin. So let's just restart that with this new config, and then it connects to chat. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to pause the music though, because and are we running? I should put this on my other screen. Yes. So spin failed, random chance. Ha ha! Get wrecked. Wait, do I not have a flashlight? Oh, yes. Cheers. Wait, was that spin and disco working simultaneously? It was. Okay. GG. I see where this is going. Oh, I should have brought smudges. Ah, never mind. I've got to sort my sense out, because that is just insane. Yeah, that's better. It's making me feel sick, so it must be even worse at your end. Well, fuck me then, I guess. Oh, and I've not got... The thing that's going to catch me out is crouch, because I'm not used to pressing C for crouch. Do I have a hiding spot? No, and it's in the garage. We've got a music grenade. Do we have any hiding? Yes, I can hide in there. Okay. And I think I just heard it yeet a plate. Is that a bone? No. The fuck me. It's just... Thing is, right, I'm really bad at playing the game with this running, because I just don't do it, whereas the guys who do use it are very good, and it's much more of a challenge to cause chaos, and it's super good fun. It's effectively, it's the same as what Psycho's got with troll alerts, which works with... is that an Eldel? Hello, sir. How are you doing? We're doing an update for TwitchPlays, so I was just showing some new guys what TwitchPlays is, because they've not seen it before. So, have at it. Oh, we've got hiding down here as well. Wait, what was that? I heard that. Oh, there's an orb. Aha! We have an orb. No, no, I really do want to put that there. So two, okay. Give us a sign. Oh, talk won't work. Hang on, I need to change my keybind for that. Because I have that on my mouse. V, isn't it? Oh, no, hang on. I'm an idiot. Let's push to talk. You want is V. Is that what I put in the config? Talk, 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 talk is V. Yeah. Point. Yeah, that's just... That's just typed in chat anyway, in the config, never mind. That only gets applied when the program starts anyways. Right, yeet. Haha, I'm still alive. I don't, if it hunts, I'm dead as dicks. There's absolutely no way. And that's... oh dear. Dun, dun. Dun 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 dun. How you doing, Elbel, anyway? Hope you are good. Why can't I turn this on? I just broken one of my. Should that be right, mouse button? Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Are you even picking up my voice? Give us crosshair colors, please. Where are you? Are you here? Yes, it's working. Okay. Let's get the breaker on. Was the breaker downstairs and I just didn't see it? Oh, come on. Ah, fuck you. Okay, let's go and. Nah, you're blocking my keys. That's a command I need to sort out. Actually, it's a freeze command, so it actually locks you in place. That's gonna be so good. Spin pretty, please. It should be cleaning. You're not allowed to do cleaning. Come on, man. You want to play? No. All right then. Weird animal. It's so that's the way the keyboard input's working. Windows just makes this so hard to deal with. What do you want? Yeah, sure. Oh no! 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 Boop on a snoot. Give us a sign. Give us a sign. Yep, it's possessing me. That's what I think it's doing. Give us a sign. Where did my camera go? Did I not pick up a camera? Oh, did that get yeeted as well? I'm never gonna find that. I feel like I'm going mad. I definitely picked up a photo camera, and I don't remember seeing you yeet it. Didn't put it down here, did I? Maybe I didn't pick it up. Did it get yeeted in the van when I wasn't outside? Oh, I see it. Didn't even notice. Right, bye then. We haven't found that. It was you. Right, okay, I know who to ban then. Are you pooping? It's not pooping. Where's the bone? Where's the bone? Is this a hiding spot? Is it fuck? Bone. Hello, boner. Oh, yeah, that was silly. Are you pooping in this one? Hello, Barn. Oh, I should get a picture of the grenade while I'm here. Ha, nice try. Any bonus? Nope. Nope. Nice try. Ain't gonna work. Nah. It's so fucking hard. What have I done? Oh, you bastards! No, oh, you've got this combo down. I need to put on slow mode now because it doesn't work for mods. Bollocks. Oh, well, there's dots. And not an Oni. Can it even be an Oni? No. Oh, and we're not going to get another evidence, are we? Where the fuck's this? Oh, there it is. Yeah, you didn't take a picture then, did you? Chat. Least helpful. So what could it be? Bonchi. Te. The. Yurei. I forgot my keybind for journal was wrong. So I normally use R. So that was inconclusive. We're gonna need to be down here in case it's a Raiju. Oh, I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. Because Banshee, we can't find out at all. Yuri, we can't find out at all because there's no fucking doors. Tei would be speed. Raiju would be speed. Yokai, I don't have any. Didn't have a flashlight, get wrecked. Okay, I don't. Shitting fuck. I'm not supposed to be swearing. Ah! Let me out. No! Let's try. Oh god, this way. I don't use default keybinds. My hand doesn't do that. It's not done any singing events, so it's not one of you. Oh, it's one of you, so I feel like my sanity drained quick, so I'm going to go with that based on not much else. It's too loud. Then we'll do some more programming. All the thing. I've not been able to read chat. I've just seen it zoom in, and that's fine by me, to be honest. So if you said anything, yokai, I was close. It was one of the two. Okay, so that's how it works, right? So, what we are doing is making it gooder. My audio level's okay, by the way. I don't think I even bothered to ask that earlier. Because it's been so long since I've done anything, and like a true professional, I didn't bother testing anything. Green, okay, Sheenie. I forgot that Nightbot command was in there. Can't wait to do a stream of that. So, funny enough, I was chatting to Otter. The other day before poor internet went to shit, because she's doing this charity stream and wanted to do collabs and stuff. And one of the things I wanted to do with this is to enable like a squad mode. So at the moment, like that just connected to my chat and only my chat. But imagine if it connected, say, hypothetically, I was doing a collab with Eldel. Say it connected to my chat and Eldel's chat. So if someone typed yeet in Eldel's, it would yeet on both of ours. It would just be absolute. Everything would be on cooldown all the time, right? And it would just be absolute chaos. But it could be fun to do for like a couple of games and then maybe just go back to normal mode or, you know, see how balanced or not it is. And, you know. Could you do, by the way, that's, this talks directly to Windows. It doesn't talk to FAS in any way because you're not allowed to mod for FAS. So this works on anything. It's still running, isn't it? Let's maybe turn that off. It works on anything. And in theory, it works on Linux as well. Which be interesting actually, because I'm running this in Linux at the moment. But yeah, two questions. Could you do like a blind one where it just makes your whole screen black? No. So graphical things I can't do. At the moment, all it can do is it effectively mimics being a keyboard and a mouse in Windows, like you'd plugged in another keyboard and another mouse, and it sends the commands to Windows, the exact same commands that your keyboard sends to Windows when you press a button or you move the mouse or whatever. That's the entry point. So there's no graphical stuff. I've never done any graphical stuff. Maybe in the future I can learn and figure it out. But then I feel like it's getting too much like Dixper. And it sort of prefer it to be a bit different. It was your idea to stream today. Ah, get wrecked. Well, I'm not going to be on too long, to be honest. So second question was, could a bot type in chat if the command failed and tag the person who tried it? Yeah, okay, so this is an issue with Twitch, right? You can connect to the Twitch, it's the internet relay chat is it's called, and you can be on receive only, and you don't need any special permissions. You don't need to be a bot or anything to do that. In fact, my connection to Twitch, if I can even find it anymore. Oh, Twitch, there we go at the bottom. I connect with to this address on this port, and the password and username is, well, the password is just random characters, and the username is, I can't remember whether it's anything at all or if that's just random characters. I think it's just random characters. Hang on, let me find it. Self.username. Oh yeah, Justin Fan with a random number. It's just I copied and pasted it from somewhere else. It can be anything. It doesn't matter. If you want to be able to send to the relay server, i.e., send a message in chat, then you need to be a registered bot. You need tokens. You need authentication. You need, and it's a whole thing, right? And that's what stream elements and the like do. Ultimately, yes, I probably can. I've just not really looked into it or done it yet. Because, like, one of the really useful things would be to be able to say, what are the commands? And then it sucks that straight out of the program with all the correct key binds and what's enabled, because the streamer can enable and disable different things. And then it just posts that in chat. Here, type, these are the things that are valid at this exact moment in time. So, yeah. So it's certainly on the cards, but yeah, I have to deal with tokens and then the distribution of those tokens and so on. Switch channel points. I think if you are a bot, so you do all of that stuff, you get access to the channel points, yes. And that's how some of the other similar bots that do things like this work, through channel points. I sort of wanted to keep it away from that because there is stuff that does it. And then the bits version is Psycho's troll alerts. And then you've got Dixper being the complete third party thing. So yeah, I mean there's lots of options. And once I've got the core to a maintainable level, like at the moment, this config file and it being a command prompt and everything is shit, right? I would love to have someone on board who can do some basic graphical user interface to make it, you know, so you've got a drop-down list or you can key in what your key binds are, or rather than it being a random config file. That'd be nice. Right, let's do some more programming with GPT, yeah? So at the moment, we've just tested, so for this new framework, press key and release key, and that works, right? So what else would we want to do? Well, mouse buttons. Okay, so let's make a frame, a class for that. So let's do, let's So it's saying press release key, not yet. So let's do press button, which is different to press a key on the keyboard because it goes to the mouse rather than the keyboard. So it's going to have a different, or it does have a different interface into Windows. So GPT is saying, we're going to call it press a button. It's going to take button as a string, which is fine because in the API it's either left, middle, or right, the words, to define which button it is. I don't know how the other buttons work in Windows, actually. What they're called. I'll have to look into that. So if you've got, you know, thumb buttons and things like that. And then the run method, so I'm just going to accept what GPT suggested here. The run method is just going to be pressing the whatever that button is. Okay, that's cool. Fine by me. And then equally, we want a release button. It's straight away, right? Because we've got a press key and then a release key. We've just done a press button, so it's going to suggest maybe you want a release button as well. And it's writing all of that for me. Lovely. And that's a nice, easy thing. So it's got that correct. Right, check my notes. Let's do... mouse movement. So, move mouse. See, it's suggesting, look, based on the other things you've got, maybe you want to move the mouse as well as click buttons on it. It's really, really good for this. And I just can just keep it in tab. So move the mouse relative to its current position. So human readable explanation here. We've got an X coordinate and a Y coordinate. And then we're going to move that relative. Sounds good. We might want to move absolute. I don't think there's probably an application for this in Phas. But this is the more traditional API. So move the mouse, moving mouse to X and Y. And so that's a point on the screen. It's probably not so useful. Relative to your current position is probably more useful. You can draw a cartoon poop, though. I've never been so in my life. It's crazy. Less user bug error. Yeah, you've got to be on top of it because it will. This is all trivial at the moment, but it will write bugs, and they're perhaps a little bit harder to spot as well because everything else surrounding it looks right, but it does write bugs. So you can't just keep smashing tab autocomplete and there's your program. So you do still have to pay attention. So, you know, that clickbait notification of, is it replacing me as a software engineer? No, it's absolutely not. Does it mean I can spend most of my thought and energy on novel and interesting stuff? And the background boring crappy stuff I just need to monitor rather than put effort in? Yeah. And that is so much more fun and enjoyable. So... so that's the mouse done. So we've done keyboard. Okay, maybe I should do... Let's just move these. Let's keep all the mouse stuff together. And then let's do all the keyboard stuff. So we've got press key, we've got a release key. We're probably going to want to do a press and release. Class use item. Nope, that's not what I want. I want a press. Let's do press release key. And we probably want a press release mouse button as well, actually. Press and release a key. So that is not what I want it to do. So here's a good example. of it not doing the right thing. This isn't a bug, it's just not what I wanted it to do. So what I want it to do is I want it to do a press key, which we've already got defined, and run it, and then await. So we need a delay in here, like that, because I'll explain this in a second. Let me just finish my thought. So then we want to do self.delay and then just run it, and then release key. Okay, it's figured out this is what I wanted to do now. Okay, super. So in most games, they are tick-based, Phasmo being no exception. If you press a button and release it in the same tick, the action gets ignored because the end state during this tick period is at the start of the tick period, A was not pressed, and at the end of the tick period, A is not pressed. So A was not pressed. So what you need to do is you need to inject a very, very short delay. So 100 milliseconds is far too much, probably. I don't know. Maybe not for files or something. I don't know what its tick speed is. But yeah, because that would make it 10 ticks per second, and it's faster than that. But that's fine. 100 milliseconds is okay. So then that means in one tick period, A was not pressed. In the next tick period, it is pressed. And then in the next one, it is released. So there has been a state change between ticks, and then that gets actioned upon. Write me a program that does X, Y, Z. Yeah, well, the thing with that is, right, is GPT for at the moment, despite being called artificial intelligence, is not intelligent. Opens a bit of a philosophical question of defining intelligence, but it can't do anything novel. It can only do things based on what it's previously seen, i.e., its training set. It can make some interpolations and things like that, that's fine, but it can't think of something new that's never been done before. At the moment, maybe in the future, I don't know. I don't know how that would even work in this type of language model. I don't think it's possible in a language model. Because all it's doing is it's looking through a load of text, just like your predictive text on your phone, and saying the last word was my. So what is most likely to be the next word? Cat. Right, so or dog or friend, you know, and these suggestions. ChatGPT just takes that a little bit further, and it looks at much, much more data to come up with that prediction, and it can produce paragraphs of text rather than a single word, right? But that's not novel. It's all just probabilities based on what it's seen before. So it's very different from intelligence. So it could write a program that already exists or is close to or uses parts of programs that already exist, but it can't write, yeah, something novel. And that's where I think it's, well, one, very misunderstood, but two, very powerful, because if you just need to set up a framework for something like we're doing here for actions that we can do in a computer game. That's not novel, that's just interfacing to Windows and pretending to be a mouse and a keyboard. Well, I don't care about that bit. I care about the what, so what the impact is, how that appears in the game, the playability, the balance, and the stuff that needs human thought behind it, you know. So try out ones that is not. Yeah, exactly. But it can't. So a language model doesn't do that. It is not capable of doing that. That's a Hollywood interpretation of artificial intelligence, and that, I would argue, probably is intelligence. A language model isn't. It's just a probability of what the next word is. It's underselling it slightly, but yeah. It's very easy to anthropomorphize a language model and make it look like it is human, particularly given, right, most customer service chatbots and all this sort of thing pretend to be humans. They have names, you know. Google have been very interesting in this. They have not named the assistant. They have not made it human, although it has a human voice. Unlike Siri has a name, and Alexa, it's very much, this is the name of a being. And it's just not. It's not a being. It's a parrot. Well, which I suppose is a being, but, you know, parrot in the sort of metaphorical sense, I guess. Oh, crap. Sorry, I forgot that's the key word, isn't it? Apologies. I get so annoyed when people say, you know, hey, and then the word of a famous search engine afterwards, and I'm playing it not through headphones, and my entire house just lights up, going, yeah, 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 what do you want, what do you want, you bastards. So we've got a press release key. We probably want a press release mouse button as well, because that falls for the same trick. So yeah, if you press it and immediately release it, Python does that quicker than the game can detect, because it's poll-based. Don't necessarily need to talk about what that means. Well, I'm happy to. So this time, it has actually suggested the right thing. It suggested using a composition of things we've already got, rather than writing its own function like it did before. Because it has knowledge of me saying, no, bullshit, do it this way. So it's taken that into account, which is quite cool. So, why is my scroll wheel being a bit weird? So let's test some of these then, I guess. So we got these here, so let's just get rid of all of that. So let's say teabag, right, is an action release with wait, press release, oh see, yeah. So this is, I put this in Eldel's general chat yesterday when I was playing about this. I've typed the word teabag. It knows that that means crouch. There's nowhere else in here is that linked, right? And I find that funny. Clearly, it's been talked about on the internet. You know, it's a thing, it's a meme. So that's part of its training model. But I just find that hilarious that it knows that in this context, teabag means crouching repeatedly. Up and down, you know, a few times. I just find that absolutely hilarious. Turn his music up to 100. Love it. Something in English on stream, and his phone woke up in Dutch because it thought he said the magic phrase. Brilliant. Yeah, it knows what teabag is. That's just funny. I think that's really cool. And it sort of shows you its ability to understand context as well. So it knows that we're pressing keyboard buttons here. I've just typed the word teabag, so it's gone keyboard buttons, teabag. Smash those two together. What does it mean based on what I've been trained on? So people talking on the internet, oh, it means crouch repeatedly. Which is quite funny. What's that say about us? Yeah, quite. So let's do that. And now we have this thing called Teabag. It's saying, why don't you run it? Well, I completely agree. And there you go. You see here, pressing key C, waiting for 100 milliseconds, release, press, release. And it's done that cycle five times, sorry, because we've got a five there. Now, what if we want a random? Probably doesn't make so much sense for Teabag, but we want somewhere between 0.1 and half a second. Okay, so we've got a bug in wait random. Oh, because I didn't, but that was my fault, not GPT's fault. Let's try that again. Oh, interesting. So it has. So I'd say that's a bug because that's not what I intended it to do. It's recalculated the random. Sorry, this random pause between each press of C. It's recalculated each time because these are different numbers. So actually, let's go into that because that's not what I expected it to do. So let's go. Why is this being silly? Action is press C. Okay. Why is this wait random? Ah, because the random is calculated at runtime, not at construction time. Okay. Is that what we want? Don't think it is. Let's just tidy this up a little bit. There we go, get rid of some decimal places. Or do we want it to calculate that randomness once and then that be the gap for the entire course of the command? A good question. I don't know. Hey, Sumi, how you doing? I'm not sure whether I want. Yeah. A random time between each one. Might have to think about that. Because I think this. So, just to. Wait time is a float, which equals a. So how do I do this? I need a post init function, don't I? So def post init is that. Let me just default that there. And then we do self dot here. So that'll calculate it a construction time. So now rather than this being different on each iteration, it should be the same but still random. Or it'll just break. Cannot assign because field is good point. point well made. I need to remind myself how to do that. Just pull up some work code on my other monitor. Sorry, yeah, I can't show this for obvious reasons. I've got to find where I've done this. Is it in this file? Sorry. Boring moment for a second. Where the hell have I done this recently? Boost in it. Ah, here we go. That's what I want. Let's not copy and paste that in though. So this is a frozen class, so it's constant, so this post in it can't assign to something. So what you have to do is object dot, you have to do a work around self wait time is whatever you want it to be. So we can just not none, we want that, right? That should work. It's a bit naughty. Yeah, okay, so there we go. Make some sweets. Oh, making some, very nice. Oh yeah, I've got some sports mix. I should open these. Never get it perfect when teabagging. Yeah. I think there's arguments for both, isn't there? So to that end, maybe there should be a maybe it requires two separate what's it called, implementations, so you can then choose which one you want. Because I'm sure there's probably a use case for both. Okay, we'll have a look at that in a sec. But yeah, so you can see this time, right? It's calculated a random quarter of a second this time. But if I, and it's then done the same quarter of a second for each. But if I run this again, yeah, it's randomly chosen 0.31 of a second this time, but done that for each. Yeah, I think there's a use case for both, isn't there? So, action repeat with wait, and then hello. What do you want? Come on, then. Oh, you're such a little... Come here. You want attention? Come and get attention. Okie dokie! Enjoy your cleaning, if that's even possible. Good to see you. And, honk. I should have put my honk t-shirt on. Damn. Next time. Who else is on, by the way? I've not been keeping an eye out. Is Dreamer not? I thought Dreamer was on today. Is he not? So, so maybe this belongs in here as an option. Calculate for each run. No, that's not what I want. That doesn't belong there. Action repeat with wait. I think it belongs in here. Means this shouldn't be frozen. What's a good way of doing this? Default that to that. If random. Okay. So now we can have a method in here, which is def calculate wait time. And then it's suggesting calculate wait time. Wait time is this, and then it's going to do an object setAtter on that because it's frozen. Which at this point, I don't think this should be frozen anymore because this is getting a bit silly. So this should now be self.waitTime. And then we can just do do that there. And then we don't need this. Let's call that recalculate wait time. Okay. Yes, okay, so that works. So now if recalculate wait, and GPT's just figured it out and I tabbed too quick and it just did it. So that's gonna do that. Okay, so action repeat with wait, is that what we had down here? Wait random. And recalculate wait is true. So now, if I run this, and let's just do it like 3 times. Typo. So now it's done, it's recalculated. So 0.13, 0.18, 0.38. Whereas if I set this to false, it's used the same one, 3-2, 3-2, 3-2. Okay, so we have a nice interface into here now. Cool, that's good. Good suggestion, I like that. And you know what, I can just run this straight off the bat. Like this. And then I can delete that, and let's just put the print in there. So now I can run both. So recalculate wait is false, recalculate wait is true. And there we go, there's our two different things, right? So 2-6, 2-6, 2-6. And then in the second one where we recalculate, 2-7, 4-0, 4-1. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Why is format document not working? Okay, sure, whatever. Nice. So, press release key. Did we have a press release button? Yes, we did. So that's it, really. We can do anything now. I think we can do pretty much anything now. So, let's create a new file. New TwitchPlays.py. Plays. Close enough. And then let's do... I'm just going to copy and paste here. Probably don't need that. Do need that. And do need that. So we'll import our action. So we're importing this file now. I don't know why my format is not working. Format document with auto pepe. Yes. Did that source? Not do a source. Do I need to install? Have I not got the end installed on here? Sorry, I'm just setting up an environment. She's in a bit of a weird mood, to be honest. Oh, I love this one. Journey of the Prairie King, isn't it? Yeah, Journey of the Prairie King. So, can I now venv? Venv. No matching commands. Can I just... What if I just restart? Oh, right, okay, it's done it this time. Cool, that's what I wanted it to do. And now I forgot why I was doing it. Oh, yes, code formatter. Home user. Oh, have I copy and pasted in a... I'm just pissing it down outside. I have. Venv bin. So this needs to be workspace dir. I forget what it is. Sorry, bear with me a second. Not got it there. That's annoying. It's dollar workspace. These capitals. Workspace dir? I'm not convinced that's correct. Why didn't that change? Oh. .venv? Is the name of the folder. Right, now we work. Home user venv. Why are you using home user venv? Where are you getting that from? Pray tell, where do you get that from? I don't know. This was working before, and now it's decided to shit itself. Oh, here we go. Path. No, that's not the path I wanted. Oh well, I'll fix that off stream. Fuck it. It won't be as pretty. Whatever. So let's do some more, right? Data classes. Sure. So what we want to do now? Now we've got this framework. We've got all these actions we can do. Do you want cat cam? I'll tell you what. Cat cam. Now we want to create a Phasmo, like presets and things you can actually do in Phasmo, and let's define that, because maybe people want to use this for other games and we can have presets for different games, right? So let's have a Phasmophobia preset actions, something like this. Preset actions for Phasmophobia. GPT, I love you. So we're going to have some default keybinds. Interesting suggestion there. I don't want that. Key binds, which is going to be a dict of a string. Now we need to do an initializer for this. Default factory is going to be a lambda, which is effectively an inline function. And we're going to have walk forwards. So these are the commands that we've sort of seen before, right? And it knows W is typically used for walk forwards. Walk backwards, walk left, walk right. Oh my god, sprint, it knows is shift. Wow, that's impressive. Crouch is C. Open journal. That's actually toggle journal, so that's incorrect. Fleshlight, no. We want place next. Place is F. So it's very impressive. Use is E. No, see, that's incorrect because E is grab or pick up. Pick up is E, not picky up. So, yeah, because use is right mouse button. So drop is G. Switch is absolutely adamant about use being E. Which, if you remember, it used to be back in the day. Switch is Q, yeah. Flashlight, no, it's a torch. I'm British, I'm calling it a torch. Fuck you all. Fork is V. Global chat, yeah, see, this is pretty cool. But we want use is not mouse one, is RMB, which I think is right in the API. But I'm going to do a conversion on that because that's just going to get confusing, isn't it? What's left mouse button in FAS? Like, use it to open doors. Is that the only thing you use it for? I can't think of anything else you use left mouse button for in FAS. Off the top of my head. In my head, zombie. So, okay. It's probably good enough for now. So now what's it reckon? Actions. So it thinks we should have a dictionary of actions now as well. Which is interesting, because that's not the way I've done it in my playing about code. But I do sort of like it. But it's a bit... No, I prefer the way I've done it, actually. Right, so let's do that. Did I have... You know how you have to press and release a key and give it a default delay? Yeah, okay. So actually, I do want that exposed. So toggle duration, because this is going to be different for different games based on the tick speed and so on, right? We're also going to want look distance. Distance is a float, and what I've been using is 500, and then peak distance. So that was a bad thing. It's 500, I don't want that. I want 250. Okay. Right, so this is some stuff. Oh, I see. I see how it is. kitty. Well, I know where we're going to be going. Does my... Ooh, thunderbolt and lightning. Very, very frightening. Wow. Is my firebolt working? This is! Hey, look at that. Do I need to make these clips bigger? Probably... What's he... What? Oh, is this Kaz hacking out? Where he got on the balcony with VR? Where the fuck's he even there?
You VR player, seriously.
Yes, it was, yeah, I knew it. Peter Kaz, exactly. Can we have a... Let's do a shouty for Kazapoo as well. In fact, have I done any shouties for anyone? I fucking haven't, have I? She'll know who else has been in. Maud has been in. Let's do all the shouties and get all the clips. Maud was in earlier. Who else have we had? Queue up some of them anyway. Elder, we did an Elder one, didn't we? Right, okay, so. Let's do some actions. So, keyboard actions. Keyboard actions. On my bed. So, walk forwards. Like rawr, rawr. Get wrecked, kitty cam. Let me just check if I got that vaguely in frame. Yeah, close enough. So we want walk forwards, which is returning a class, but this is a function. So I might break a bit of convention here and do camel case. So this is going to return. It's thunderbolt and lightning, darling. It's going to return an action sequence, and it's going to do a keyboard press of the keybind walk forward. It's going to wait the toggle duration and then release the key. Okay, so how does that differ to what I had in my notes? Quite, Jesus Christ, look at that. Wow! Flipping, hang on, let's do on one of them. Bloody monsoon outside. Is that even going to show up on the camera? Sort of. Get it bouncing off that wagon. It's absolutely hammering it down. It's beautiful sunshine about 20 minutes ago. What the fuck? So we would like walk forward, so I'm going to write this first one out. It's a member method. So star comma means that anything after this must be a keyword argument rather than a positional argument. So it means if you want to specify any of these, you've got to do duration equals this in the call rather than just putting a number in. It's a contested topic. I think it's a fantastic feature in Python. Honk! I've just added honk as well. I've added it to BTTV because Gil Honkdemer was in. And I realised I didn't have honk, so I hope you don't mind. I've pinched honk from me. How you doing, Mark? There we go. See if all of this works.
So top players in the last 24 hours are number one. Sniper's Zaun, 93.3. 65? 65? That's a
Oh, mate, that is funny. Oh, you're on mobile. It's basically Hypo having a seizure. That was brilliant. I love that. Duration float. Okay, so ChatGPT. Now I've given it a bit of a clue of what I wanted. And that returns an action sequence. No? Oh, but an action sequence is an action, so yes. Ah. Yeah. Okay, wicked. So, walk forwards. So what we're doing, Mort, is we're doing this Twitch Plays thing. Have you seen this in action? Oh, you're on mobile, though, so you can't really see it, can you? I love the old lobby, and I like the old van as well. Yeah. Oh, you're welcome. Need to do that as well. Dr. Blue Dwarf, fucking hell. Hello. And Jess as well. Hello. How you doing? I need to do one of them. Have I got any left? Yes, I have. Hey, Jazz. Let's do a shouty. With Jazz. Here we are. So, yes, we're doing a bit of chat. GPT does my job for me. Sheesh. So, this actually isn't what I want it to do. So, ChatGPT, you're sacked. So, the key is either going to be the key the user passed in, or... Right, let's figure it out now.
I'm having that as some sort of chat.
Or self-key binds that, but this is not the way we want to access it, because that will throw an exception if it is wrong. So, we want a default in there, if it gets deleted from this, I mean. Oh, we're going to have a double definition here, though. So what I want to use is I want to use the getter. Which has a default argument, so rather than throwing an exception and everything blue screen of deathing, you get that if it fails to find walk forwards in this dictionary. In this hash map, whatever. But now we've got a double definition of this, which I don't like so much. Feel like that needs abstracting out somewhere. Think about that later. And now, so now what we want to do, let me code this one and then we'll do another demo of how Twitch Plays works and you can have some fun and try and get me killed again. We want an actions. We want a keyboard action. No, do we? Keyboard. Sorry, scrolling far too fast. That is horrible. Keyboard action doesn't even exist, does it? No, it doesn't. So if I did that... So no, ChatGPT, you sacked again. That's not even valid. What I want is a press release key, and we want key, and then duration is duration or self.toggle duration. There. So if we do a walk forwards and we can test this, in fact, let's do exactly that. Just copy and paste some code over here. And let's do preset is Phasmophobia preset actions. Sure, we can do all the prints. And then we can do preset.walkforward.run and see what happens. Okay, let's run it. And we got an error. Unexpected keyword argument duration. Shouldn't be that. It should be that. delay because I can't type clearly. Let's try again. There we go. Hey, it worked. So here's our key binds, crouch is C and all the things. And then we did walk forwards, which press W for 0.1 seconds. Maybe we need to change that. Yeah, that's wrong. That shouldn't be that. That should be like 3 seconds or something is our default. So let's just try that again. Waiting for 3 seconds and then releasing W. So then that you would have walked forwards, right, for 3 seconds there. Nice. I'm liking this a lot. Can I come out of that? Shall we do a demo? Let's do a demo. So, where did I put it? It's in here. Twitch plays. Connected to chat. Let me just pause whilst I open up Phasmo. And then you can go nuts. And there's a peaches as well. Yes, I'm good, thank you. Gonna go and grab a shower. Hopefully still on wants to jump out. Yeah, cool. You're probably already in the shower by now, so I've been ignoring chat. Hi, dis not peachy. Dis Mads! Hey, Mads! I have a sword. Oh, shit. Wow. Good luck, everyone. You're all getting banned by Mads. See you all later. on Peach's computer. Mads is in charge now. No, we're all doomed. Ooh, what other ones have I got? I went absolutely nuts and added in far too many BTTV emotes. let's add. I want to add a. Can I add 4 smudges and a litter? Is that how that works? Close enough. 2 smudges. I want 4 though. Add. Could have sworn I clicked that 4 times. There we go. Right. Stranglewood. Ready up. We're in. I'm good, thank you. Right, okay, so. Jez, you might find this quite funny, actually, and everyone else who's not seen this. Who is Dr. Blue Dwarf? That's, I thought it... Is it Mew Mew? I can't remember whose alt that is. Oh, damn it. So, TPC in chat like this. So that gives you the list of commands you can do. Let me pause the music. And then let me start Twitch plays. Super. So you can see there, you can type in chat forward, back, left, right. Look left, look right, look up, look down. Drop, swap, journal, light, talk, crouch, and all these things, right? So if you type any of that in chat, it's going to do the respective thing on my keyboard. And we are playing a nightmare mode, so thank you for the crouch. And we're in fog as well, so good luck me, I am going to fucking die. So first things first. Oh, bone, nice. Can't hide there. Can I hide in here? I can hide in there, okay. No music box. Oh, and I can hide behind there as well. That's generous. You watch it be in that fucking room now. Can't hide there. There's nothing in here of interest. Is it the cards? It's not the cards. I just heard a throw. Is it the doo-doo doll? Oh, I'm so dead. Oh, fuck me. It is the doo-doo doll. And it's immediately evented, so... And it wasn't a ball of mist, so it's probably an Oni. Get wrecked, I know what you are, bitch. So, are you in here? Don't see any orbicles. don't see any orb calls. Screw you, I was looking on that. Are you in here? Is that an orb? No, that's just a reflection. Yeet! I heard that. Oh, I don't have... Did I not bring an EMF? Oh, it's going absolutely bonkers in there. Well, I can get a picture of the bone, I guess. Bone! Yeet. Oh, and it's turned the breaker off already. You need a teabag one? Well, why don't you try the word teabag in chat? Something like that then. Is that what you wanted? Of course I've implemented teabag. There's a couple of hidden ones. There's another one called spin, which I think you might enjoy. The hidden ones only have a 50% chance to work, but there is a bug, so if it doesn't, so that failed, the 50% chance. But the cooldown doesn't work, so you can just spam it. So you just try again straight away. Which is so broken. Teabag is on cooldown. Actually, let's put you there. Oh my god, it's going absolutely bonkers. Is this a Polty? This might be a Polty, you know. Spin failed again. Just... Oh, bollocks. Just, you can... So, until the command works, the cooldown doesn't start. Failed again. Unlucky. Three times in a row. So, yeah, until it works, you can just keep spamming it. And then once it does work, then you have to wait for the cooldown, which is like, I don't know, 30 seconds or something. I forgot what I set it to. It is going bananas. Like that. Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Oh, fuck you. Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Where are you? What do we need for Polty? Spirit Box Fingy's writing. Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Definitely no orbs, is there? Let's put that down. Fingies! There we go. Nice little handprint. Booping on the window. So, Fingies. I reckon it's a Polty. Are you going to be a dick with writing? I bet you are. Bet you are. Is that three or it's a three? There's no way. It's throwing everything. Give us a sign. Are you here? Are you close? Where are you? And I'm so sorry. Can I be a Goryeo? You can. So let's go and watch for dots in the van. It's very active. Crap, thunderbolt and lightning. Spin. Yeah, it's good, isn't it? Well, annoyingly, I'm going to have to fix that bug that means you can spam commands. Which is a shame, but then we can always change the cooldown, right? Yeet. But we can add so many, like I want a freeze command. That is like number one on my to-do list. So it literally just blocks WASD. So it freezes you in place like for a second or something, I think would be plenty, because that during a hunt would just be brutal and I love it. I want sky as well. So it does the bend back and you just look straight up. That is just fucking brilliant, or floor. Konami, I've got on my list there as well. There's the Konami cheat code. I forget what that was. And then two others that have rubbed off, annoyingly. Lower the chance of fail. Yeah, it is configurable in the config, actually. So I can make it, you know, only a 25% chance to fail. In fact, let's do that now. So we have... Teabag is... I can't remember which way round I did this. Is that a percent chance to work or percent chance to fail? Can't remember. Let's just save that and restart. Random chance, 25%. Okay, so it's to work. So we want that to be 75. Okay, so it should be a 75% chance to work now. Connected. Okay, go but wild. We've still not seen dots, I don't think, so I don't think it is a Goryeo. Dance and make you look up or down. Yeah, exactly. So that's sort of the idea with the Konami cheat code, isn't it? So it's up, 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 down, down, left, left, right, right. Or what, I forget what it is now. But it'll be like forward, forward, back, back. You know, look up, look down. It'd just be like chaos. Headbang. That was the one. Sorry, Pippa, you're going to have to go. Sorry, darling. I'm going to write this on my whiteboard. Hang on. Headbang is one that needs to go in. Headbang. There we go. It's on the board. Which is fairly obvious. Look up, look down, look up, look down repeatedly. Oh my god, you're molting cat. Shit. Let's go and see if it's written in that bloody book yet. I don't know what my sanity is. But I probably don't have much. Controls inverted. I can't intercept commands. I thought about doing that, actually. Not an Oni. Fuck off, fuck off, fuck off, fuck off. Yeah, it got me. I thought about intercepting keyboard commands, but then it becomes a keylogger. I'm a bit sketchy about installing that on people's computers. Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Particularly when Windows Defender throws an absolute hissy fit when you install this, because it's like, this is not verified software because you didn't pay Microsoft 200 quid for an exception in Windows Defender. Assholes. So, I don't know. Can I hide in here? Not easily. You give me my other evidence. I bet it's EMF. It's a 2. Give me a 5, you stinker. It's a 3. I mean, we didn't see dots, so it can't be a Goryeo. Even though we're on Nightmare, because it has to give dots. It's still very yeety. I'm fixated on this being a... Where's my camera? Oh, you suck! Nope. Nearly had that. Justice for paper. Can you hear that? It's yeeting everything. You so fucking nearly had me then. It's 100% a palsy, surely. Hmm. Oh, you fucking fuck! It's just... I wonder what the other evidence is, though. It's gotta be... It's spirit box or writing, but it's just refusing to write in the book. Write in the book! Write in the book! Write in the book, you bitch! Write in the book! I suppose I should check these thingies just in case it's an obarque. Oh, I touched that when I was hiding in there. Oh, you fucker. Give us a sign. Are you here? Don't have a flashlight on me. I've learned the hard way. Nice try. I mean, can you hear it just throwing everything? It's a palsy. I'm just gonna GG. Is that the end? Yeah. Okay, thanks, my ghost! So you can imagine, right, in a busy chat, there's like a couple hundred people in there, and it's just hilarious when that happens. It's just chaos. It is so fucking funny. Oh, it's writing in the book. I don't know if you can see the pen moving. Finally. Finally. It's definitely a palsy because it's not the other two. Got him. Nice. Survived twice. Love to see it. You fucker. There's no way. There's no way. Yeah, if you're holding anything electrical, switch is a good, really good one. Oh, here's one I'm going to add as well. Drop everything. So it does switch, drop, switch, drop, switch, drop. And I could do use everything as well, which would be quite funny. So switch, right mouse button, switch, right mouse button. So then if you have a smudge and a lighter in your inventory, it's getting got. But if I put the pauses to like, I don't know, half a second or something, there is a chance that you could spam G and the streamer could throw it quick enough before it gets used, so that could be fun. There's fucking no way it's smiling. I'm uninstalling the game. So yeah, so that's what this does. So what I want to do is turn the volume down on my headset first. So let's kill that. Let's do a few more. In fact, let's flesh out the rest of these, what we want to do in Phasmos. I am on edge about this, though. So what I might do is def make default keybinds Phasmo. Yeah, I don't like that. Oh, and then there you go, look, GPT has just said this is what you want. Perfect. Right, so now I can get rid of this bullshittery. Click. And I can just call that function. And then... This is going to get made every single time now. But no, that's a backup. Okay, fine. I suppose I could just have a def get default keybind phasmo and then action. What am I doing? And then action is a string and it's going to return a string. And it's going to make the keybinds get the action or none. Which is probably okay. I think that might throw. So let's do action equals walk forward, see GPT just typing it for me. That's what I like. And it will do that. So it'll get the action from our keybinds. And the fallback is just get the default. So if it's not specified, we'll just use the default. Which actually maybe we don't want to do if it's not specified. Perhaps we just don't want that command to work. That makes a lot more sense, actually, because then you can just delete the keybind and then it yeah, that makes a lot more sense. So let's just simplify that. Talk myself out of it already. And then that's going to return an optional. If key, else none. So this will return the action if the action is found, otherwise it'll just return nothing. Okay, fine, I'm happy with that, I think. So walk backwards, and this is where GPT is just going to kick this out of the park now. With a smudge, use is a better one since we can waste it before it hunts. Yeah, timing can be tricky. Yeah, absolutely. Oh, Sumi, when you saw me playing Faz the other day, it was with Old Dog Jez when you were saying, was I playing? They've started playing the game. So, yeah, good fun. So walk backwards is that, and it's figured out, walk backward. Is it backward? Yes, it is. Okay, fine. Or none, and then if we do it, do the things. Okay, so GPT's just going to write all of this now for me, isn't it? And I only just need to check that it's used the right thing, which actually that doesn't need to be there. Walk right. Oops. Walk right. I don't even need to read it. Sprint. I need to think about, actually. In fact, have we even got sprint in here? I do. Let's skip sprint for now. Toggle crouch, get crouch or none, and do the thing. Press release key. Yep. Happy days. Def journal toggle. Toggle journal. See, it's just so much quicker than typing all of this or copy and pasting and making it a mistake. Place. Yep. We want place. Pick up. We want pickup. Is pickup the key we used? Yes, it is. Drop. Yeah. Switch. I'm just going to change the name of that. Switch item. Yeah. Torch toggle. Yeah. I see it's just doing all of this for me, and this is what I like. Torque. Oh, that's interesting. Did I not have... Yeah, I don't want toggle though, so I want def torque. And then... So we want duration to be different for that. We want this to be like 10 seconds default. Talk. Which actually reminds me, similarly for walking, we want 3 seconds. Oh, and it's done it for all those, and then realize we want 100 milliseconds for all of those. Sweet. It's learning mouse actions. Okay, let's do the mouse ones. So we want... def. Yeah, we don't want look with coordinates and things. That's not what we want to do. We want look up. Right. And this wants a distance. It's going to return an action. And it's going to move mouse relative distance or that, and it's a minus in Windows because minus is upwards on the mouse. Fucking yes, mate. So down is positive, and it's done that. Look left is, oops. Left is negative, comma zero, which is correct. And right is positive. Yeah. I didn't murder them at all. Well, I say that, actually, I did once, but it wasn't intentional. We were all at, like, 90 sanity, lit the summoning circle, and... Oh, actually, was it a banshee? I can't remember now. No, it wasn't a banshee. And it didn't have a grace period in the circle. So I got a photo, and it immediately... rip someone's face off. It didn't do the head wobble for a few seconds so you could smudge it. And that was the guy's first game as well. That was funny. So, but I don't know why it did that. It shouldn't have done that. We were on amateur. Look up left. No, we don't want any of that. But we do want peaks. So def... Heat up is going to use distance or peak distance. Yeah. Peak down. There's a bit of repetition here, actually, but not overly bothered. Yeah, we can probably make that a bit better, actually. But... up, down, left, right. Okay, so now we just have the mouse button to do. So def use item is right mouse button. So key... So that's wrong, because it's not a key, it's a button. Because it's on the mouse. Do we have use in here? Yeah, RMB. So it's going to be button or button. And then press release button. Because it's on the mouse, so it's a different implementation. If button, else none. Perfect. Dun-dun-dun. Right, so now all we have to do are the spicy actions. So we want teabag, Walk forwards and use. Oh, mate, some of the suggestions this is going to come out with is going to be so fucking good. So tea bag we want, which is going to take not that. So self, we want a key. We want a duration. A string or none. Equals none. We want a duration, which is a float or none. Oops. None equals none by default. And we want a repeat. And this is where we can get quite fun and spicy here because of the randomness that is part of this new version. So I'm just going to auto-complete all of that. So, we're going to get our crouch key bind. Yeah. The duration is going to be... is probably not what I want to call it. Going to be the pause, isn't it? So you crouch, and then you pause, and then you crouch again, and then you pause. So let's default that to what, like just under half a second as a guess, maybe. And then repeats. Can be that, or right now I need to remind myself. Press release button, nope. Action repeats with wait. How do I want to do this? Do I want to implement this, but with a random times? Maybe. Or we can just import random. And then what we can do is... Sorry, scroll. Repeats is repeats, or random integer between 5 and 10. So we will teabag inclusively between 5 and 10 times. So you don't know whether you'll end up crouched or end up stood or how many times it'll be. So adds a bit of fun in there, right? So what we want is a press release key. In fact, is that what we want? A press release... press release key. I don't think that is what we want. We want an action repeat with wait, don't we? Yeah. So that's wrong. Action repeat with wait. And then you can simplify this by using the crouch method. Crouch toggle using a key for times, wait, and then recalculate. So, number of repeats, wait with the pause, recalculate wait is false. Yep. Excellent. So let's just test that. So let's do teabag here. Let's just run. Okay, that did what I hoped. So it did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 crouches with 0.4 seconds between each one. And it was pressing C. Whereas if I say, actually, I want the pause to be like 1 second between each one. There we go. We can see it actually pausing before printing out on the screen. Awesome. And if I want... a specific number of repeats. Repeats is 1. Actually, that might be a bug. Yeah, so it only does it once rather than repeats once. That sort of doesn't make sense. But okay, fine, whatever. I think that's fine. And what we can do, of course, is if we have a different key bind. What we should be able to do is say our key binds are that, and then change crouch to control, and then we can pass our key binds in when we create that, and now it should press control. Oh, it does, it fucking works, it works. Get in. And we can pull these keybinds straight out of a config somewhere, or a graphical user interface, or whatever we want to do. Oh, brilliant. I likey-likey. So that's teabag. Let's do the other ones we've currently got. So we have disco. Disco. Which is going to have an identical interface, so key, pause, repeats, and it's going to get the torch keybind, and it's, to be honest, it's going to be like, it's exactly the same as this. Yeah, it is exactly the same implementation, just different key. Okay. Def, let's do cycle items. That's how easy it is to make a new command. I like this. So this is going to be, again, identical, I think. And that called torch toggle. This one's going to call switch item. Yeah. Don't give it away, ChatGPT. Soon, TM. So cycle items and use. Cycle items and use is going to have a similar interface, but we also need a button. Can I... Let's just make that a bit wider. So key, and we also need button, which is a string or none. So key is switch, button is whatever you asked for, or use, which is right mouse. Pause, and then the number of times to repeat this, it shouldn't be, it is 3, you only have 3 items in your inventory, so. So what we want to do is... Now we need to build a command here. So the action is... an action sequence. Action sequence. So this is more complex. I'm down for that. And then we give it a list of switch item. And use item. Do we want... Action repeat with wait. Yeah, we just need a wait in the middle of here, don't we? So we want an actions.wait of pause seconds. So we'll switch the item, we'll pause, we'll do the use button, and then actually, no, that should be toggle duration, right? Toggle duration. Should it? Action times wait. No, I think that's correct. I think that's right. Recalculate wait is false. I can just get rid of that. So I think that's what we want. Let's try it. See what happens. Okay, didn't like that. Missing a keyword argument. Button. Cycle items and use. Oh, I didn't put none there. Right, so let's dissect this. Pressing Q. Release Q. Wait 0.4 seconds to give the streamer a chance to yeet it, but that's very, very quick. And then right mouse button. Then we wait 0.4 seconds. Yeah, maybe we want that different. And then we do it again. Q, pause, right mouse button. Q, pause, right mouse button. Yes, perfect. Perfect. So we can then pretty much copy and paste this to do like drop all items. So key okay, so this needs to be different. So that needs to be key cycle and key drop. So, and then we can do key cycle and then key drop. Let's just propagate that through. And this is switch, isn't it? Sorry, it should be key switch, not key cycle. Yeah. I need to change that naming convention because that's... Okay, fine. Repeats is going to be 3. Pause is going to be the same as that. And then it's, yeah, it's going to be practically the same as this one. So we'll make an action sequence. It's going to be switch item with that key, pause, and then drop with key drop. Okay, so drop all items now becomes QG. Fantastic. Nice. Now, one thing we've not really talked about is why I'm doing it this way. All of these should be able to be passed across a process boundary. So we can put that in a queue, and then another thread or another process can be then executing this. So then we have a thread handling chat, so that doesn't get backed up. A thread doing the parsing, maybe, and then a thread actually integrating with the keyboard that's got all these pauses in, and we don't want these pauses interrupting the Twitch chat relay, because if you pause for too long, the server will kick you off. So they need to be in different threads. So what have we got for the spicy ones? Teabag disco, cycle items and use, drop all items. We need spin. Left spin. Right, okay, let's auto complete that. I don't think it makes sense to have a pause in there. So we want a distance, which is an integer. Maybe we do want a pause in there, but it's going to be a different pause, so I'll explain what I mean in a sec. Pause, and we can have a direction, which we currently don't have. Which can be a string or none equals none by default. So spin, right. The distance is going to be whatever you passed in, or if you didn't pass anything at all, it's going to be self.lookDistance times random uniform distribution, excuse me. So we will spin whatever that look distance is plus or minus 50% to add some random into that. I like it. The duration, so the pause, actually. So it's going to do that, pause, do it again, pause, do it again, pause. Because if you just, in one game tick, move the mouse a certain amount, you'll just teleport there. So you need to do it over a period of time, but obviously quickly so it looks smooth, but not instantaneously. So we do need a pause between each motion. So, yeah. So this is going to be a bit ka-chunk, isn't it? So this needs to be like 10% of that. So we're not doing a 45 degree turn at each thing, which is going to look very, very ka-chunk. So we'll just do 10% each time and then do it 10 times more, and then you get a finer resolution. I think that's how I implemented it in the old one. So pause between is going to be significantly shorter than that. So maybe 10 milliseconds. Game tick's probably not that, though. Let's try 50 milliseconds. I'm not sure what the game tick is in Phas. still might be a bit quick. Hello! Honk! You missed the demo! We'll do another one in a sec. And then we'll raid. Yeah, speech later, mate. Yeah, I might be up for a bit of Val or something later if you fancy it, or Faz or whatever. Have a good one. So that's that. So the repeats. Ah, okay, so how many times do we want to do this? Right. This needs a bit of random in as well. So repeats or random.randint between 5 and 10. Probably needs to be more. Maybe between 50 and 100. Oh, I don't want to test that though. That's going to spam the thing. So let's just put a to do. Calibrate this. Okay. And then direction, so this we currently can't do, but direction is on, oh, it's GPT has nailed it there. Direction or random choice between left and right. And then what we can do is not that. We can do if direction is left. And that's wrong. That's not what I want it to do. I want it to return actions repeat with weight. Look left for the distance, for the number of repeats, is it that order? I think it's got that in the wrong order. Oh no, repeats and then wait. Okay, yeah, fine. Like that. Otherwise, now I won't do an elif right on here. I'll just do a else. If it's not left, it will go right. It's just a bit of meh. You could throw on that, I suppose, but... Nope, never. Nope, Valorant's never been toxic. Never once in its life. So that is spin. So now what? Spin and use. Spin and drop. Just yeeting stuff out as you're spinning. Oh, that could be fucking chaos. We're going to need to figure out how the fuck cooldowns are going to work on this. But that's going to be a higher level. So what I'm going to do is let's just put a that in there and then a pause. Let's print that out and then let's just try this spin and see what it calculates. Module random has no thing. It's rand uniform, isn't it? To get a uniform. No, what is it? Oh, it's random.uniform. Which gets us a uniform distribution. Perfect. So we are going to spin a distance of that much. Let's just put... Let's just format that a bit better. There we go. So that's random. So 37 each time. So on my screen, it depends on your resolution and all sorts of stuff. So this is configurable. But for me, about 45 degrees is about 500. So we're going to do 37, 70 times, which is brain no worky. 37 times 70, and then divided by 500 is 545s, so divided by 2, So it's about 270 degrees, so it's about three quarters of a turn that time. And it's going to go right with a 50 millisecond gap between each one, so it doesn't look too ka-chunk-a-chunk. And then this time, 30.17, 50 point. I think this needs bumping up a little bit. 73 times, 81 times, 90 times. Maybe it's okay. Do I want it to go over 360 degrees? Probably. Alright, we'll try it when we get that far. We'll see. Cool. Okay, well, that's actually as far as I wanted to get today anyway. And this all works. So let's finish up then. Sorry, Stardew. With a demo. One more time. I've survived twice. Let's see if we can improve on that. Brains are hard. Yeah, tell him about him. That's given right up. Flappy flap. So, right, if we do, would it possible to make you unable to drop items for a drive? So that requires interception of keyboard, real keyboard commands. I don't know, I could be convinced, but I decided not to do that. Let me talk to you while I just quickly grab a drink. Because then effectively the software becomes a keylogger. Because I am reading what you are typing, right? Because I need to read to see whether or not you press the button to intercept that, to then forward it onto Phasmo, or not forward it onto Phasmo if I'm blocking that key, right? I am quite uneasy about that. I mean, I know my code isn't going to log it, save it to a file, and then send me your bank details, right? I know I'm not going to write that. But I just feel uneasy with it, that being how it works. Because it's open source and someone could do that. I mean, it's not exactly hard to make a keylogger anyway, but I don't know. I'll think about it. And there would be a performance penalty if I am sucking in your keyboard commands and then so they don't go to Phasmo. And then I output them to Phasmo. So either I just pipe them straight out or change them. So Jez had a really good idea. I think it was Jez, of inverting your commands. So if you do W, it rather than sending W to Phas, it sends S. So forwards becomes backwards, you know, so on and so forth. And same for the mouse, which would just be fucking hilarious. Do that for like 5 seconds in a hunt. Wow. But I feel like, yeah, I don't know. I need to think about it, to be honest. Hello? Fucking interface. Holy shit. There we go. Add. So I have a smudge. I have a thing. Sanity pills are cheating. So let's go in. When you walk through the door, yeah, no. I'll just instantly fucking rain again. Seriously, game. Let me just sort my sensitivity out, because that is disgusting. There we go, that's better. Right then. Exclamation mark TPC in chat. To get your list of commands that work, because those ones I've just programmed aren't in this version yet. So, exclamation mark TPC. It's turned on. Have at it. Go butt wild. Da, 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 da. Hiding spots, please, please, please. Nope. You pooping? Give us coloured crosshairs, please, kinetic. Fuck you. Oh, my keybinds. I'm not used to C being crouch. It's horrible. Hiding spot? Yes, hiding spot. Bone. Not heard anything yet. Another hiding spot. Oh, you are good to me, game. You are good. No mirror. Don't need to even look in there. Cards? No cards. Sad. No circle. Breaker. And the spicy commands aren't in that list, so there are more, which I'm sure Sumi will give away. For example, go on, I'll give them away. Disco. It's the peanut butter hand. Disco is one. Teabag. Spin. Do we have lockers as well? No, we've already got two hiding spots, haven't we? Ah, haha, disco doesn't work because I've got the flashlight in my hand. Oh, hello, ghost. Yeet. Well then. Hello. Yeah, because the keybind for turning a flashlight on and off is different if it's in your hand versus in your pocket. Which I don't understand why they don't make T also work when it's in your hand. For consistency. Might be my demon. Oh yeah, it's fuck me. So that was more than 360, wasn't it? Yeah, so maybe I do need to up that in the new code. So, have a book, have a dots, and have a... have a camera. And then have one of those next to the book, so I know when you've done it. Thank you. And I'll be taking my Colk. Yeet. Da fuck. Okay. Still alive. This is good. I will survive. As long as I have my Weetabix, I know I'll stay alive. Give me your dots or your orbs. I bet the orbs are behind that. I know. Let's put in freezing. Why didn't journal work? Wait, why didn't that work? Oh, you missed the R. You spelt it wrong. Journal. Yeah. Fucking cat jam. Cat jam, cat jam, cat jam. Maybe it's not dots. I am so gonna die. Jam cat. Have I got jam cat? I need to add jam cat. Do I have jam cat? No, I don't. I should have jam cat. I don't think I've got rat jam on there either. No very dare. Ah, door toucher? Fingerprints? No, no fingerprints. Book? No book. Where are you? Are you here? Are you close? Are you friendly? Where are you? Are you friendly? How are you? Where are you? Are you? Fuck you. Are you fucked? Where are you? 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 No. Okay. Maybe it's not that then. Which means it's probably EMF. Give us a sign. Fuck me. Give us a sign. Give us a sign. You better not touch my Colk, though. Yoink. Give us a sign. Have you moved? No, it's still freezing. Where are you? Give us a sign. Give us a sign. I'll teabag your face, ghost. Give us a sign. I see. Where's the saw? Oh, the saw's in the garage, isn't it? I want my saw. Because you saw nothing. It's on there, isn't it? Oh, I need the light on. I can't see shit. Wait, can I not pick the saw up? Oh, I thought you could. I thought that... Fucking hell. I thought the ghost could yeet that saw. Huh. Is there one in the garage? I'm sure there's a saw on this map, isn't there? Wait, do I have hiding down here? This could be bad. No, I don't. Ah, there is a saw here. Ha ha! You saw nothing. Green stinks as dirty and as fucking hell. Junie, I know it was you. Yeah, you saw that. But did you see this? Dun dun dun! Oh, it didn't work. Did you see? Nope. Wow, you can tell I've not played in a while. No, come on, I can do this. No, turns out I can't. I'm a big fat phony. Wait, why can't I do this anymore? Ah, oh, close enough. No, it's not. Wait, why is this not working anymore? Am I just... Have I lost my touch? Oh, no! We changed collision? There's no way. Oh, that was nearly it. This is fucking what? That went behind the TV. That's quite funny. Oh, come on. Oh, what? Hey, there it is. Hey, oh. Why is this so hard all of a sudden? It used to wedge in there really easily. You didn't have to put much effort in. Oh, there we go. Done it. That's the one. You can get my Colcom there, and then I can get my other Colcom there. Got him. Clipboard work. I don't know, actually. No, you throw it horizontally, or vertically, I guess. So no dots, no orbs. Freezing. Not an Oni, because it hissed. Wait, did it hiss, or was that the last game? Can't remember. Not box. Writing thingies EMF. Oh no, not thingies, because it touched the door. So can it be... Ah, oh, seriously? Can it be an obake? No. Anyway, so that's thoroughly unhelpful. All right. I see where this is going. No events yet. Okay, thanks. It's all blurred into one. Where's my hiding? My hiding's there, isn't it? And there. No book. Give us a sign. Are you here? Where are you? Are you here? Fuck you. Where are you? I heard that! Okay. So, writing. And it did that while we were in the room. Oh, fucking hell, it's still on the list, but it hasn't hunted yet. It must have done that through the wall, I believe. Well, we need a hunt, right? What was our... It's the monkey paw, isn't it? There's a new meta with this, isn't there? that I've seen everyone doing on Sunny Meadows. Where you like get a hunt, then get it to unlock the door, and then you can photograph it through the door and just get a shitload of money. I wish to see the ghost. Not a rev. Well, I just said shade, but it wrote in the book while we were in the room. And I think shade's blocked from interacting when you're in the room, isn't it? It's blocked from interactions and hunts if you're in the room. I think. Oh, okay. So maybe the book doesn't count as an interaction for triggering it. Triggering the book. It counts as an interaction for photo. Okay, that would make sense. Yeah, I could understand that. Okay. Probably not a Moroi, because it was normal speed. Unless I've just got very unlucky. No, Moroi would need to be box, wouldn't it? And it's not box, so it can't be a Moroi. So it's demon or shade. I think you're right. I think you are right. Look, it yeeted that cup. Yeah. Think. Oh, do I not have I thought I had a camera. Where's my camera gone? Where are you? And I'm so sorry. Should have got a photo of the ghost when I did the thing, shouldn't I? Hey, Catherine! Ah, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me. No, 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 no. Let me get another smudge at least. Holy crap, give me a chance. I'm good, thanks. How are you? We're just finishing up with a cheeky game. We've been doing a load of programming with ChatGPT and stuff like that, seeing if it's going to put me out of my job. And we're just doing a demo for guys who haven't seen my TwitchPlays stuff before. So feel free to go absolutely nuts in chat. Exclamation mark TPC, if someone can do that to list the commands. And then, yeah. I've had it. I've played, this is my third game, and I've survived all of them so far. Because chat are bad at getting me killed. Yeah, I said it. Get wrecked, chat. Failed random chance of 75%. Ha Da, 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 da. I just want it to hunt now, don't I? Oh, wait, I wonder if... Yeah, because I did a monkey paw hunt then, didn't I? So my sanity isn't low enough. Ah, oh, it is. It's so a shade. Yeah, you're completely right. I don't know what my sanity... Oh, fuck me. I don't know what my sanity is, otherwise I would use sanity one to... knock it to 50. But I sort of feel like I'm probably lower than 50 anyway. Maybe not. Does the monkey paw reduce your sanity when you use it? I don't think it does it? And why have I used two things? I've only used one, haven't I? I wish to see the ghost. Yeah, you can't do the same one twice, can you? Ah, this is just nightmare. Teabag failed random chance, get wrecked. Oh, do you? Ah, oh, I didn't know that. Yeah. In fact, actually, no, hit me. You just double event me, you bitch. Oh, I'm gonna sit in the dark. Goes down to 3. I did not realize. I see. Double event from a shade. Oh, fuck you. I want that. Can't believe no one's done talk yet. Get wrecked, and fuck you. Okay, I didn't want that anyway. So, although opening doors is really, really hard to implement because they can be pull, push, left, right, I've just realised, actually, if you're in a closet, it's always opening outwards, isn't it? So that would be a good one to implement. So it's a press left mouse. Oh, and that just opens it straight off the bat. Oh, okay, interesting. But it's press left mouse, walk forwards. Or press left mouse, move right. But you don't know if it's move right or move left, so I could just have that as a random choice. Shit. I think there's a way. There's a way. Enjoy your brekkies.
I will survive.
Come here, Dodo. I'll save you. Oh, fuck you.
Oh, my God.
Right. Survived my third one. Get wrecked. Which means I need to add more stuff in to get people killed. Shade. I think it's a shade. We think it's a shade. We're doing it. It's not going to be a fucking miling again when it was clearly a poltergeist. Ugh. Shade. Yeah, GG. Nice! What you can see in the log, so you can see it, like the move in the mouse, pressing C, so that was teabag. Teabag failed random chances and things like this and stuff. That's the spin with a very unhelpful error message. Drop throw yeet is already running, so that was done twice in succession, so it ignored the second one because it was already doing it. So yeah, this is all the old version that everyone's currently using. Well, I say everyone. Those who are using it are using it. Using that version. So yeah. So it'll be good once I can get this new one out that we've been looking at. Not you. With this in, because all this stuff, like dropping all items, cycle items and use, like we can do all of this stuff. And, oh, we can do headbang. Shall we just quickly implement headbang just to sort of show how easy this is? Spin and use, I think, is just going to be... No, spin and drop will be good. Headbang. So we want self, we want a star comma. And this is going to need a distance and a pause and a repeat. Oh, so yeah, okay, GPT's got it. So we want, oh, it's got half of it at least. Distance is going to be. Do I want that to be a smooth animation for the extra complexity that that will bring? Probably not. Yeah, interesting actually. That's. So I want you to fully look up and fully look down. So that needs to be a not a relative move. This will need tweaking. Pause will be pause or half a second. That's a bit slow. And then repeats or random in between 5 and 10 sounds pretty good to me. And then we will do the action is going to be an action sequence of look up with distance, right? Is that what we need to put in there? Yeah, distance. And then a wait. And then a look. Look down with distance. GPT filling it in for me. And then we want to return the repeat of that sequence. So we just want to repeat that action, that repeat number of times with a pause in between each one. Super. There's headbang implemented. Done. And I guess we can just prove that. Can we just run that? Could it be that easy? Nope. Takes one positional argument, but two a given. Why does lookup not take a distance? Because it's a named keyword argument. Distance equals distance. And then look down is distance equals distance. There we go. And there it goes. Fucking hell, that's brutal. That was a good number of repeats. So look up is negative, down is positive, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Fucking hell, that's gonna be so cool. Oh, I can't wait to put the actual back end onto this new code, because that so then we can actually jump into the game and actually see what it looks like. That's gonna be cool. Right, well, there we are. Helpful GPT, pat pat pat. Yeah, exactly. Right, so let's do with one of those buttons, and then I think we're going to go and see Sheenie. I think we are. Our Dreamer's on as well. Oh, I want to raid Dreamer. Well, I want to raid Sheenie as well because Sheenie is just fucking incredible. But Dreamer is using Twitch plays. Right, okay, I know what we can do. We'll go to Dreamer because Dreamer is in fact, is he actually using this now? Hang on, let's just
What?
do a let's just do a quick test. Do a drop in chat. Yep, he's absolutely got it turned on. Right, we're gonna raid Dreamer. But if you're looking for some art, Sheenie is currently doing some art, and Sheenie is amazing, right?
Oh my god.
Thank you.
Yes, that is spooky.
So please do go and say hello to Sheeny as well. Jesus. We'll go and raid Dreamer, and you know what the commands are now. So we'll go and raid Dreamer.
My precious.
I'm not creepy at all, Sheeny. Oh, raid sub. Why am I doing that? I don't even have fucking... I don't have that. I'm an idiot. Right. Thank you so much.
Are you a Pokemon now?
She's still going. So, yeah, let's... Yeah, I know, it's just muscle memory, right? So, yeah, thank you very much for swinging by, everyone. Hope you had fun. This is looking really good, actually. We're going to make some progress. I'm going to make some progress off stream with it as well, just to expedite getting it, getting a version released for the, you know, for the actual professional streamers. But hope you found this interesting. This video will be going up on YouTube as well, since I'm not allowed to co-stream, although... dual stream, although I argue the British interpretation of their rule is perfectly legal. But anyway, yes, enjoy. Good things coming. So see you later. Let's go and annoy Dreamer and spam all the Twitch Plays commands. See you later. Have a good weekend.